Y'all, what is going down, y'all? Welcome in. The most underrated podcast you already know.
Hell yeah!
Broadcasting from Most Underrated Studios, I'm your man, Thomas the Franchise. The homie, Dal Palantonio, chilling across from me.
Yo!
Think about this.
It's confusing, yet dramatic enough.
Hello.
To keep me enticed.
Hello. Hello. I might just let this breathe for a second. What's going on, chat? How you guys doing, man? Happy New Year's Eve to everybody out there. That build is kind of crazy.
It makes me think of nothing else. I'm so entranced.
Yeah, it's, I never heard this.
That kind of trance music? I'm entranced.
Entranced.
You like that?
Nice one, Dal.
Thank you.
Man, a lot of people in the chat already. What's going on, guys? How you doing? Oh, look at that drop.
I don't like this.
You know this song?
I do. But I don't like how this fits together. I'm out on this one.
It's a little bit, what is it called? This fucking music called EDM. Mm-hmm. All right, let me just go back to your regularly scheduled programming. 90s hits. That's what we do. 90s hits. 90s clips.
Nice.
All right, man. Oh no. What happened? Oh,
there it is.
Chase in the chat. He was trying to get a GoFundMe going for the show, trying to be...
I saw that.
Incredibly generous. And the GoFundMe link, he's trying to post it in the chat. Dude, it won't let me unblock it. Like, it shows me what you're trying to post, but it doesn't let me unblock it in the chat. So, Choner, I appreciate it. We love you. Thank you for trying to raise some money for the show as a going-away present. The link is on his Twitter as well, if you want to do that. At Choner Man. But yeah, dude, that's why it's not showing up in the chat. I can't even make it show up in the chat. So every time I click show, it says error, try again. Really, really whack. Goldeneye, what up, bro? How you doing, man? My Amperto's up in there. John King, Black Prez, DL Kicks, Fail Beast, my man Skinner, Adam Woodall, what's up?
Oh, man, Sneaker.
Eli Soto, what up, bro?
Sneaker Gill is back. Put them shoes on the table. God, I haven't seen him in a minute.
Sneaker Gill, how appropriate.
We're on the last show.
That's so funny. Have you ever seen anything like this?
God dang.
Yeah, top threes. What are these called? The gold toes. Gold toes are fire. Mm-hmm. Isn't it weird? Isn't that kind of weird about Jordan 1s when they start to name them and they call some of them the actual toe box color is gold, so these are called gold toes.
Right.
But then they call certain shoes, like the black toes, black, and the toe isn't even black.
Mm-hmm. It's just the surrounding.
Like when we talked to Chris about the Union 1s, they call those the black toe Union 1s, and it's just the outside. It's a completely different piece. The area that's black on this shoe is what they call the black toe. Why? Right. Who makes these rules?
I don't know.
It doesn't make sense.
Is it the sneakerheads that make those rules?
It has to be Sneaker Gill. Jason Ramirez, $4.99 in the super chat.
Oh, man. Great start.
How's it going, bro? Had to tune into the last cast. Sad to see you guys go out like this, but best of luck to both of you in the new year. Man. Thank you, bro. No, that's the thing. It doesn't need to be sad. Like, there's no sad. We did a lot of good shit with the show. It sucks that the show can't move in, but it's not like this was a failure or we're going to be failing, like, moving into the next shit we do. I've had a couple people just going back and forth in DMs and stuff and talking about dreams and like, oh man, you know, your dream's going to die or, are you still going to pursue your dream? I think Neighborhood asked that another show and stuff. Dude, I was one of those kids. I've had a million dreams, bro. Mm-hmm. I was never one of those people that had one dream and just went super hard at that one dream. Like, I've wanted to do a million things forever. I wanted to be Rob Dyrdek, dog. I just wanted to do it all. In a bunch of different areas. I've never just been a one dream kind of guy. I mean, it changed five times when I was a kid. You know, I wanted to I'm sure I wanted to be a firefighter at one point, and then I wanted to be a football player once I figured out, you know, 8, 9 years old, how to play football and do all that. And then I'm sure I wanted to be something else. And then I wanted to rap, and then I wanted to produce music. And then I wanted to write songs. And I've had success in so many little areas. And whether you consider this a success or a failure, whatever this area is, it's a 2-year period of life, right? Like, I've had dipped in out of so many different things where I've had success and not had success. So whatever you consider this, success or failure, I've been on both sides in a bunch of different shit that I tried to dip my fingers in. But it's never just, I thought about it a lot. It's never just one dream for me. Mm-hmm. my girl says it all the time. She's like, because I can do it all, man. Jack of all trades, master of none. Mm-hmm. And that's me. If I had one dream, if I had a singular dream, I'd be doing that. I'd be those guys you see that find the thing they love at a very, very young age, and that's all they love, and they just shoot to the moon with that. That's not ever been me. What about you? Dreams-wise, how do you feel about that?
Yeah, for me, I wouldn't say I'm as much of a dreamer. I'm just kind of a hard worker, and when I find something that somewhat works, I usually fall into that and perform very well.
Right, that's why doing this cast and stuff was super risky for you, like super out of the box for you, like way against everything you've ever done in life. To me, this is just the next step. I'm going to do some new shit. Just like I continue, I always do some new shit every few years. Like, this isn't new to me, but for you, a big step. Like
every
you said,
bit of
you're
it
a pack
new.
Your fucking lunchbox, go to work guy, work that's hard, it. Pound the pavement, mm-hmm. stack money in the bank, get, you know, level up at the company. We're completely opposite in that way, you know, but that's why, you know, I give you a lot of credit for this, man. It's for what we've been able to do here and for what you've been able to do. But I think this was necessary for you to figure out who you are too. Find your path, maybe get away from that a little bit just to figure out who you are and what you like.
Right.
You know, and if you really do like that, I think it's always good for people to do that.
Oh, totally, man. It expanded many horizons. It taught me a lot of stuff. Running your own business, even with a partner, is really tough because then you have to build a team. You have to get all these people in here that try to have the same vision. And we found that, you know, a struggle for the most part. Stringer didn't have the same vision. Great kid. Jalal didn't have the same vision. Wanted to do his own thing, and that's cool as well. But nobody had the love like we did, you know, for our show that we created. And then obviously having a team, man, I can't go back to it. I've ran so many teams. And in this case, it was tough. Like, how do I run this? How do I run certain aspects of this? We're buddies. We're friends. Where's the accountability? Where does that lie? There was a lot of interesting turns that this took on running a business with kind of a partner. And not that it was bad, not that it was good. We learned a lot through it. And I think if we ever did come back with this or something else, we'd be even better. I've got no doubt about it. No
Absolutely.
Doubt in my mind. You know what I mean? And it's been a hell of an experience, man. And again, the community, going back to last cast, the community that's been built because of this, the people, the relationships. We talk about Misha, who's helped us out with the cast, our homie Chris Roberts.
Dude, it's been so cool. I'm so glad we did this the way we did. Like, I'm so glad we gave it a few episodes to burn. We let people know, like, yo, this is going down. We're going to continue to do a few extra shows. And just let it burn for a little bit. Let people get their full thoughts and, you know, have people call on the show. Like, Goldeneye had to do whatever it took to make the live today, he said in the chat. Like, there's a guy that he catches it on demand most of the time because he's working or whatever. I don't know what he had to do today, but I'm sure he had to make some moves. I'm sure he had to move some stuff around to make it happen. So it means a lot.
Yeah.
I'm glad we gave people the opportunity to do that and didn't just pop up one day and be like, all right, we're folding up the shop, you know, and that's it. It's good, dude. I enjoy it. I'm enjoying what we're doing here.
Well, yeah.
Go ahead.
Well, Failbeast is even ahead of us. He's already into 2021. If you didn't
know. Oh, shout out to
Failbeast. Now you know. So somebody from the future, the most hungover cast, he is here for it. And we appreciate that.
Funny.
Well, did you bring alcohol? I didn't bring any alcohol today.
No. No. I probably won't drink tonight.
Yeah, I won't either, probably.
There's no... I won't drink tonight. I don't really drink that much, though. Mm-hmm. I'm not really a drinker much anymore.
I don't either, because then if I'm hungover, I have aches and pains and I have headaches, then I have COVID.
Yeah.
I don't want to bring that on.
It takes me a lot to get in that zone. I think the last time I was really like in a zone where I was drinking every day for a little bit and my body kind of got used to it was Vegas 2019, March Madness, AP's bachelor party. almost 2 years ago now. Because we were there for a few days, and you start getting like in the habit of grabbing a beer every time you go down to the sports book. Sure. And then, it, you know, that beer, all of a sudden, it doesn't taste like beer anymore. It's kind of like, all right, so, you know, that Bud Light turns into a BL smoothie. And all of a sudden, you're just having a good time. Betting games, yelling at your bracket.
Yeah.
Yeah. The good old days when you could go outside. That was fun.
Hmm.
But
John King says, that's not how COVID works. I know, fool. I'm just in my head. If I have any symptoms, man, then it's over. I was just telling Franchise this morning.
Yeah.
Yesterday, dude,
I was a little scared.
I was at work all day, and man, I hit the shitter 4 times. It was crazy. And I start looking at COVID symptoms. I talked to Robin about it, and she's like, oh my God, babe. Diarrhea is definitely a big part of COVID.
Here we go.
Now I got COVID. Because I had diarrhea a couple times, you know what I mean?
Jeez.
So you got diarrhea, you got COVID.
Squirts equal COVID. I don't know. I had my squirts, and I don't know. I took 4 dumps yesterday, so I probably won't have to take a
four dumps in one day?
Oh, dude, I probably won't have to dump for 2 days.
Oh, dude, it's like you ate some lettuce from Mexico. Four dumps in one day, guys? That's some bad shit.
Sir Dump Truck over there at the PGA Superstore, you know? I don't know what's going on.
Literally in Mexico, they tell you not to drink the water.
Oh, sure.
Oh, yeah, dude. I drank the water one time.
Oh, you get Giardia.
Accident. You're just like not paying attention, all fucked up. Man. Just have a bunch of water. I don't know if I didn't get like super sick, but I had the shits. It was the worst, bro. Yeah,
totally.
Absolute worst.
Oh, man.
Chat's on fire today. Not long. No more glasses inside, TTF. Come on, brother. I mean, maybe. I don't know what I'm going to do next. I don't know what's going to happen. Who knows? Pinky ring inside. See, glasses inside. Chains inside.
Dallas got the mask inside.
Underwear inside. Out. What up?
I had to turn mine inside out after yesterday.
Did you?
Oh, yeah.
I bet you had to go do a couple changes, 4 shits in a day.
I needed a man pawn.
No, but I don't know what we'd be doing next. It might be glasses inside. It might not. Who knows, man? But I know what I will do is I'll always continue to keep it 100.
Yeah.
I'll always continue to do what I do, the way I do it, move the way I move. It's worked out for me. Being myself has always been great for me, including in corporate environments. I feel like you've been around me in corporate environments. People, my supervisors, the people who gravitate towards me, they almost come in my direction, not the other way around.
Mm-hmm.
And I've had success with that in life. People... I attract an energy. I don't know. It's hard to explain. I'm not trying to sound egotistical or anything, but I'm just telling people in general, if you have someone like that telling you not to be you, like my man is here in the chat or saying, don't wear glass inside or whatever you do. That's my advice, is just continue to do you as long as it's been working. And for me, it's been working. If you're a drug addict, I'd say maybe make some changes, but if you do you and it's working, and you bring an energy to the room, you know, that's made you successful in a bunch of different arenas. That's me too. And so I'm going to continue to be me and do what I do in every room I walk into, because I can only be myself. And if I tried that at a young age, didn't work well. What I tell you, probably from third grade through all of elementary, I was my desk was by the teacher. Why? Because I was always myself. Never one time could I sit with the rest of the class because I was just continually me.
You're too much.
And it got me through. It got me by. The teacher had nothing but good things to say other than when I was distracting the class. So she had to just move me away from the class. It's been since a young age, man. Young age. I've been that same way.
Shit, I'm surprised I'm not wearing glasses in here yet.
I would encourage people to do... I would encourage people to do the same. Yeah, just do you, man. What's up?
Sorry? I'm surprised I'm not wearing glasses yet inside.
I was going to wear the mask today. What do you think if I just pop up with the mask on today? What do you think everyone would think?
I wonder if I should take mine off for a quick second, remind people that I do have a face. Maybe I'll...
I don't know if that's necessary.
You don't think it's necessary?
I think you've been...
I think I'm pretty tight?
I think you've been pretty cautious.
Pretty cautious, right?
No doubt. I mean, Dal eats his breakfast in the car. Obviously, you guys know we have the plexiglass divider here. This joint.
Pretty sick.
Yep. So, really dope. What is this? You know what this song is?
Sound like Ozzy for a second, the Crazy Train.
Blind Melon.
Ah.
I know. Who knew the intro was like that? It did sound like Ozzy.
I didn't know that. I have this album.
It's the music video, I guess.
Oh, okay, gotcha. That makes sense then. Shannon Hoon, lead singer. Died at 27.
Couldn't tell you.
Shannon Hoon. What's his name?
Oh, I thought you were asking me. No. Shannon who?
No, Shannon Hoon is his name.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
I thought you were giving me a quiz. I was like,
super
tell
sick.
You.
Yeah, man. This guy, you know, he had a lot of mental struggles, is what I would say. And drugs, the whole thing. 27 years old, man.
A lot of those 90s lead singers, dude.
Bradley
the grunge,
Noel.
Huh? The grunge singers. Fuck, all suicides.
Kurt Cobain, Bradley Noel.
The dude from NXS. Remember strangled himself with a belt while he was jacking off?
Michael Hutchinson. That's
remember that guy?
Yeah, dude. Janis Joplin, even you know, way older, obviously, you know, in generational speaking. Jimi Hendrix, all 27. Jim Morrison, 27.
Yeah, you're going back now. Yeah, 27.
So, 27, bad. Tough year.
I got to be honest, Eli Soto, I got to be honest. You guys talking about life a little deeper over the last few casts, making moves has inspired me to make moves, the moves I just made. Thank you. Wow, Eli, I didn't know that, dude. I saw that you were making some moves. I didn't know we kind of inspired that, so that's sick, dude.
He's onto a new career path, yeah?
Yep. I saw that. Exactly. And that's all this is. That's all this is about. This isn't about anything more than making moves. Making moves, trying to level up, trying to get better. And I think that's how we should all look at it. You know, we're all losing something we love. You guys are obviously losing something a couple times a week. We are too, but it's all for the next moves.
Mm-hmm.
For the next moves, man. You gotta make certain sacrifices to make certain things go.
Hey, no doubt.
And that's where we're at. Daniel. I keep hearing the pros and cons of the cast. Sounds like an opportunity to rebuild and come back strong for MUP 2022. Maybe me wishful thinking.
Yeah.
No, dude, it's funny. Dal and I were talking about this before the show today, and I didn't know how the show was going to go today because we did so much talking. We never have talked this much before the show because we're always prepping. We're always getting our information and everything together. Well, this ain't that kind of show. So there's not as much prep needed. Well, we're talking about all this stuff this morning, and getting into it, man, you really do see so much more clear when you're not in it. And it's weird. We're still technically in it, but because I feel like my mind has moved on and like I'm excited for the opportunities in 2021, especially like just the early part of 2021, just talking to different people and different industries, and it's the same industry I'm in now, like just the possibilities of different things happening. There's a lot. And the show has kind of held certain things back in some regard. So there's an excitement there. But once you also step outside of this, it's easier to see the mistakes in a way. Kind of like what you're saying, Daniel. You're able to see, there's more clarity. Like, oh, shit, you know? Man, this is what needed to be done here. This is the piece that needed to be moved here. This is how we should have done this. And it is easier to see. And Dallas was saying this morning, he's like, I've heard you get a crazy clarity on your deathbed in a similar way.
Mm-hmm.
Like you are about to die and all of a sudden you have this epiphany or you have this, all this clarity over your life and the mistakes you made or maybe certain decisions you made. And you're like, gosh, this is all so easy now. But is it really, or is it just because you're dying? You know what I mean? Like, it's the same thing here. Like, is it really all so easy now, or is it that you're moving on and it just seems so easy?
There's just no stresses and pressures anymore. It's like, you know, whatever's going to happen is happening.
It's a weird
and that,
feeling.
That clarity is just like everything's lifted right from your shoulders. And it's just like, oh, damn, wish I would have saw that earlier.
Yeah.
Wish I would have ended that earlier.
Exactly. Yeah,
all these things.
That's what I'm talking about. It's just, it's very interesting, man. It's an interesting a set of emotions, and I'm like I said, I'm pumped for doing it the way we did over a few, you know, the slow burn over a few couple weeks or whatever, over a few shows. It's really been, oh, it's been great, man. Mm-hmm. It's been the ability to chop it up with you guys on social media, the ability, you know, to get back to all you guys in DMs, and I know I'm still getting back to some of you guys here, but all that's just been really fun.
Yeah,
it's been so fun. So I've really enjoyed it. Brian Jackson, it's easier to see things as a whole when you're looking at it from the outside, just like you said. You never look at the time to stand back. Oh, I'm sorry. You never took the time to stand back and look because you were so busy being in it.
That's
exactly.
True.
Exactly. And that's why I think about this show. I think about, like I said, other opportunities outside of here. I was so consumed with the show, I wasn't looking at any other opportunities outside of here. You know, people reaching out to me, different things. Like, I was 3,000 on this. Oh, and that's probably a mistake in hindsight, you know? There's a lot of other shows and a lot of other guests and a lot of other things that we didn't maybe take advantage of, people we could have collaborated with to get the show to more viewers, all that stuff, you know? And like you said, when you're in it, you're not thinking clearly sometimes. You're not as clearly as you could be. It's the best way I can say it.
It's true.
Yeah. Don't worry, fools. We all getting out. Are we all getting it in? We all getting on it in Vegas when the Rona goes away. Jesus. Sorry, Fail Beast. I apologize. I've been needing liquid for a minute here.
You'd be sounding like Brendan Schaub, old king of dyslexia on King of the Sting. Reading his live reads. Oh, yeah, it's bad.
Live reads, though? Live reads are supposed to be prepped. Live reads, you know what's coming in. Comments, you're kind of, you know, on the fly.
He doesn't sound prepped. Just saying. No shots. I noticed that.
That's just a weird way to write that, too, anyway. Don't worry, fools. We all getting on it in Vegas when the Rona goes.
Maybe it's Australian.
I'll say...
Maybe that's some of that Aussie talk.
Throw another shrimp on the barbie.
Yeah.
Let's not.
As John King would say, the dingo ate my baby.
What was that? That little, I forgot, like TikTok or video?
Oh, yeah.
TTF, I was listening to episode one of the cast. You said you didn't want to cast social media. Who told you to create one? Honestly, I'm not sure. Jalal, maybe? Did we create that when Jalal came aboard, or do we?
Yeah, I think so.
Maybe Jalal.
Yeah,
and you know, yeah, if he was going to run it, I mean, you saw what happened. We didn't really utilize enough, like exactly what I said. Like, I just didn't want to. I try not to give people too much double content on just IG and Twitter. Like, I try to keep them fresh content on each. You know, sometimes you mix a little bit, but I try not to. But with that, I mean, you're just doubling up content all day, left and right. Stringer did a good job with the IG when we first started it.
Yeah.
He was running a lot of sports posts and a lot of really good stuff with that. I got to give a lot of credit to Stringer.
Whoa, yeah!
When we first had that. He did a really good job with it.
Yeah.
He did really good.
When are you going to hit us with that ringtone? You got that?
What ringtone?
Sting. I don't know if you still have that. That one's pretty good.
Where's all my Stringer sound? Oh.
Spring. Yeah.
So funny. Thomas Yee, that's why I love history and reading autobiographies. Helps me see where successful people have been and the decisions they've made. Seeing how they overcame their failures. Good point, Yee. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's a great point. Great point. By the way, Yee taking second place in the most underrated podcast league. Shout out to Joey Magana. He did end up taking it down. Smashed it. We are going to do Collins, T-Buck. We're going to show some shoes really quick, and then we'll do Collins. What are we at? Yeah, that's fine. Because I know if we start doing Collins and all this shit, we're not going to get to any shoes. So let's do that. I don't even know what we have in studio.
Shit, man. Did you see what I undead stocked today?
I'm looking on feet. Let's see. I was this close to copping the yellow pair.
Were you?
Absolutely.
You still can.
I think the yellow pair is awesome.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I still can. And they're under $5, I believe.
Yeah. Dude, these are even cheaper.
The greens?
Oh, yeah. Dude, the off-white rubber dunks, man. I like these, dude. It's such a skate silhouette for me. And, you know, it takes me back to the Osiris days, the DVS days. And as I would say now with a global pandemic, the better days, as a matter of fact. When kids were kids, they'd loiter. They'd hang around skate shops. Had no direction. But in a different way than today's kids and future. It's just different. But maybe it's because of electronics. You know, kids back in the day, even though they hung out and loitered and maybe were shitheads, they talked to each other. They expressed things. You know, they hung out down the block. They went to friends' houses. And now, shit, man, you have all you need in your own house. You'd be gaming by yourself.
Right.
Against all these virtual people. And it's just a different world. But that being said, I love this silhouette, man. I thought this was the perfect one. I'm kind of a dunk guy this year. You know, bought a lot of dunks, and why not wear a hype dunk today? Even though it's not really hyped and resales in the shitter. I think it's cool.
Well, I think they're
a great shoe.
Yeah, I think I don't like that pair as much.
Mm-hmm.
The Gravedigger joints.
They are.
That's what those remind me
yeah,
of.
Yeah, dude. What's his name? Something Anderson? Shit, what's his name? Not Robbie. Steve. Dennis.
Dennis Anderson. Nice one down.
Yeah.
Dennis Anderson. It was, there's been so many Anderson. Like, I was going to say, like, I was about to say Morton Anderson. Remember that kicker for the Falcons that had the single bar?
Oh, dude.
Old school. He was kicking to like 43, 44.
And he wore two different shoes.
Yeah, yeah.
You know,
Morton Anderson. Yeah, holy shit.
Wore a black and a white shoe. His black shoe was the kicking shoe.
That's funny. That popped into my
most tight.
Popped into my head. Classic stuff there. Yeah, so what shoes? What do we...
Oh, yeah, let me grab them here.
What do we have going?
I brought a golf shoe in.
We got some shoes in studio. I don't even know what we have. A golf shoe? Oh, that's right. I remember you got those. Dal, I find those rubber dunks hard to tighten. The laces don't like the rubber eyelets. Is that true?
That is absolutely true. They are hard to tighten, but more importantly, they're hard to loosen, obviously. So the only way to wear this shoe is Hypebeast Lace It. There is no reason to try to tie this shoe. So if you think that it's going to be a little too big, it's very true to size, I will tell you, if you don't have it. But the only way to lace this bitch is Hypebeast. Because it is. It's a bitch to tighten, dude. Look at these. These little green eyelet holes here.
Yeah.
Dude, they're so hard to pull and loosen through those two sets on both sides. Awful. Awful. So just keep them Hypebeast.
Interesting. Yeah. So if you're really trying to regular lace them, they're a bitch, huh?
It's not a good gym shoe, Failbeast. This is not the gym shoe.
T-Buck, I would rather have a pair of D3s than those rubber dunks any day. Dallas is grabbing the shoes. Like I said, I have no idea what we had.
All right.
You remember those D3s, those Osiris?
Yeah.
I don't know.
Yeah, I can pull them up on.
I don't skateboard, so I probably, eh.
Muzzy and I both had a pair of these. These shits are wild, dude, from back in the day.
Do I need the gloves for these or what?
No white glove treatment. So if any of you fools that are tuned in watching, these are the D3s that he was talking about on the screen. Definitely resembles, like I said, the Osiris days, the D3 specifically. Definitely resembles the off-white rubber dunks that I have on today. The thick, chunky upper that is just so 90s skate. You know what I mean? Early 2000s. Just the epitome of greatness back in the day. But could you wear them now? I don't know.
No.
I don't remember. I don't remember if they're heavy. It's probably not a shoe I'd wear today. But
they look heavy. Those are kind of heavy, though, aren't they?
A little bit.
The sole?
They're a little heavier.
It would be heavy.
Yeah, they're a little heavier. Sure. But check these out, dude. What do you know about the Jordan Low 5 Wolf Gray golf joints?
The Wolf Gray.
The Wolf Grays. Joints. Yeah, these are the barking. These are the barking dog shoes. The Wolves.
I love it.
Dude, I think these. Dude, tell me as you look at the materials. Tell me these shits just don't feel and look quality.
They do, dude. They look really, really good, actually.
God, don't they look awesome?
Yeah. Everything about them. Even like there's like a little bit of tumble in the Nubuck, which is dope.
It's really nice, dude.
These look great. These look really good. I'm not a fan of fives like this normally.
Right. And it's low. It's low, right? And you don't like fives anyways just because of how much padding they usually have.
They're just a clunky shoe. It's not a shoe that's like super practical for wearing around much. That's why, honestly, I think the Jordan 1 has become so popular and it's become... I mean, it was already a staple of my collection, but I think a lot of people's collection because they're wearable for a long ass time and they're comfortable. Like the leather, if it does crease, it does get beat up. It doesn't crease to the point where it's hurting your feet unless you got a super shitty GR mid pair, you know. Yeah. Maybe my highlight reel leather could be questionable for a long period of time, but a lot like the newer ones, dude, the materials are, it's just hard to go away from that silo. When you start getting to the fives, the sixes, the sevens, the eights, damn, they start getting heavy, clunky, and just hard to wear, and the toe box is creasing and hitting, banging into your toes. If you know what I'm talking about, maybe yeah. everyone doesn't have the experience, but I do.
I think
I just don't find them.
I think of eights when I think of like one of the most bulky, heavy shoe.
Right,
man. The eights are, I mean, some of them look okay, but man, I haven't seen really great on feet picks, and they're just not practical daily.
Right,
you know
right.
what I mean?
Yeah, exactly. They're not a regular shoe like you just want to throw on and wear around. And if you do, and you break them in, then they do start to get more comfortable, but they look like shit. Like once you break them in, they just look terrible. So, but these, dude, these look so good. These are, go to your camera. Let me show the quality here.
Yeah, the quality is really, really insane. I would say, and you know, if we want to really go down and dirty with you, just to be honest with you fools, it looks like where they glued the upper to the actual midsole, there is some glue marks that you will see. There's some quality control issues around where the upper does meet the midsole. So if you're not a glue fan and wanting to see a bunch of glue, there are some issues with this shoe. And I think it's on both. Mine's actually a little worse than the one Franchise has in his hand. But yeah, there's some glue issues. So it seems like these might have been rushed just slightly. But I will tell you, outside of that, quality wise, the new buck, the tumble in it is fantastic. The new buck is fantastic. The 3M on the tongue, obviously a staple. The icy bottoms is super dope, and I think that'll stay icy for a good amount of time because you actually have spikes that keep you above the ground. So you might have a little bit of play in that. The spikes are, for you golfers, are replaceable. Some Jordan 5 golf shoes, the spikes are what they are, and you cannot replace them. But these have the two prong, so you can actually replace these with what they call soft spike spikes that you can get at your local retailers. So I think this is a shoe that not only am I going to use on the golf course, but you know, if it didn't have the spikes, I'd wear this on the daily. Like if it was one of those spikeless golf shoes that a lot of companies have now gone to, man, I'd wear this on the daily. But yeah, man, really
I
happy,
agree, dude.
Really happy about the shoe.
Very, very cold.
You know what's not great about the shoe is the GR, my most hated Jordan box.
Oh yeah, right.
Dude, I hate this Jordan box. This Jordan box is so infamous and awful that I would, I think we should give it a funeral. I hate this box. I think Jordan Brand needs to kill this box. This box is awful.
Yeah, I got some of those. It's funny. I had one of those. I was going through my shoes the other day and I was like, oh, what are these? And it was those Jordan 11 bread mid cleats.
Oh yeah. Uh-huh.
And I was like, oh man, what are these doing? I looked up on Goat. Jordan 11 mid cleats are going for anywhere from $325 to $400 right now.
Yep.
Is that crazy or what?
Guess who sold his?
Did you have mids too?
No, I had the lows. But
okay.
Guess what I sold my lows for?
What?
$315.
With breads?
Bread lows.
Dude, I was looking at bread lows and they were $180.
$315
in the bread low cleats, but yeah. The mids are $325.
You know when I did it?
Why?
Right before the bread sneaker release. So there was hype. There was something brewing, right? With the bread 11 coming out. I sold them 2 weeks before the Bread 11 dropped.
I wonder why they dropped all cheap in the lows, but the highs are high.
I don't know.
Or the mids.
I don't know.
Were they mids, I guess.
Yeah, yours are mids. Mine were the lows.
Right.
Yep.
Interesting.
So I got rid of them bitches.
How crazy. Why'd you get rid of them? You want to play in them?
Because I would never use them. I bought them for Turkey Bowl. Like,
right.
Remember 4 or 5 years ago when we were doing Turkey Bowl every year?
Absolutely.
We had something to use them for, and I was like, fuck, I was using baseball cleats or softball cleats. So I was like, man, if we're going to do this Turkey Bowl, maybe I can start throwing one. Maybe the most underrated can host one. I'm like, shit, maybe there's a reason. I'm going to buy some cleats.
Mm.
Never used them once.
Yeah.
You know.
Same boat. I'm there. I bought them too. And then I like knee issues and just ankle issues. Stopped playing flag football as much.
Right.
And there you go.
Let me grab the other pair
sitting.
Here.
They're $325, bro. I couldn't believe it. All right. He's getting some other shoes here. Let's see what he got. GoldenEye, Jordan golf shoes probably have the best materials. The leather on the Air Jordan 11 Golf is real leather and super soft.
Hmm.
Nice. I'm trying to think if I've seen the 11 golf shoes. So look them up. Look them up here, GoldenEye. Well, Dal's grabbing those. Oh, yeah. Yeah, those white ones. Remember those?
Yeah, dude.
Those are so clean, huh?
They are.
Those are extremely clean.
They're so clean that I wouldn't want to wear them on a golf course, especially when the golf course is put on the blue fertilizers. Oh, dude.
Wreck them.
Oh, you would turn those bitches so bad.
But what about the icy soles on the The Wolf Grays.
The Wolf Grays? I don't know. I'm not so worried about that.
Your girlfriend.
We'll see what happens. We'll see. Love that. We'll see what happens. I don't know. But, dude, here's the box. All right. See if you can guess this bitch. Obviously, you can because it says it on it.
Stupid. Okay.
Adidas.
You and the 4D love.
4Ds.
I don't get it. How many do you need?
You know what? I've been selling a lot of them. I'm trying to get picky. I'm finding the right ones. I'm finding the right uppers and which ones are softer and which ones are more true to size. And you know what? These bitches fit like a Cinderella fit, dog. These are fire. These are like the cream 1.0 uppers, a.k.a. the Adidas 4D Ultra Chalk. And notice I didn't say chalk. I said chalk. Probably wrong again, Black Prez.
It's a good job by you.
Thank you, man. Fix your own shit, you know what I mean? What do you think about these, dude?
Dal, you know what I think. I mean, how many times I have to say?
You are so out.
It's just it's an Ultra Boost upper.
You are so out on 4D. That almost sounds like our
the only one I'm interested in that social status collab. No one ever hit me up. I was like, anyone got a 12 and a half?
Yeah, nobody.
Because they said I had to go to a half up, right?
Yes.
Yeah. No one got a 12 and a half, I guess.
Yeah, because these are kind of tight ankles. They're not as tight though as the new 1.0s that are on the Ultra Boost. But I'd still go a half up. I did in this case. These are a 10 and a half. I like these, dude. I think these are just clean as shit. This might be the best summer shoe.
Clean as shit, fellas. Go ahead.
This might be the best summer shoe. This is going to be the summer shoe.
The sheen on the cage makes it look like a women's pair to me.
I could see that, I guess.
Look at the sheen.
You see a sheen. I see classic.
Look at the stripes. They're like a. It's like if your lady went in and she just wanted like a little shiny base coat for New Year's Eve.
It's almost like my lady bronzed my shoes. I think they call it a bronzer.
No, that's not bronze. It's just like a little... Dog, it's just a base coat.
Oh, is it?
It's just like a little... Just give me that... Just a little pop. I don't want nothing eccentric.
Okay.
Just a little shine.
Just a little sheen.
For New Year's Eve.
Hmm.
You know?
I think you can buy that stuff at Walmart for $4.
I don't know. Yeah, that's bothering me, bro.
It's like a shoe glitter, almost. Just give it a little sheen. Give it a little pop.
So that's my own. So yeah, if I'm giving you, besides all my other takes, you know what I already think.
Mm-hmm.
But that's
why would you buy 4D when you could have Boost?
All that.
Love that
the sheen. Now it's just, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Dog, I mean, yeah. That does make it look like a girl's pair, bro. I don't know why. Why did they do that?
So you're saying I should go hit up Boosted Stripes, see if they can help me out? Give me a mat.
Nah, I think you should just continue with the plan that you've been doing and just keep selling these.
Keep selling them.
I don't think you need
them.
Any Boosted Stripes. I don't think you need anything extra. Just put them on the market, guy. Put them on the market.
Get them out of
You're
here.
You're not going to wear those, Dallas. Where are you going to wear those?
Oh, I'm going to wear those.
Those are going to get so dirty.
Yeah.
Where? When? When and where are you going to wear those and why? What is there ever an occasion to wear that shoe?
I definitely will not wear those at a concert.
Right.
That would be awful.
Okay.
I'd wear those somewhere indoor, you know, so when we go to like a thrift con, say we go to a sneaker show, because I imagine those will exist one day yet again. And I'm excited for that day. I'm going to have enough comfort. Those are going to be more comfortable than a Jordan 1. You could not tell me that. You could not tell me now. Because one, you've never wore one. But two, you cannot tell me that shoe, that upper with the 4D that is not as comfortable as Boost. No doubt.
Yeah, yeah.
I will not lie to anybody and say, oh, fools, you got to try. It's not that. It's not great. It's
right.
not as great
right,
as Boost.
Right, right.
But you can't tell me that I would not rather be in that shoe than a hype Jordan 1 at a sneaker con, at a thrift con, when we're on our feet more than 6 hours a day.
Absolutely. I know you would.
That's
but then
where I'd
I would ask you. First, I'd slap your face and say, why are you wearing that, though, when you can have an Ultra Boost? So, yeah, I get that you don't want it. This is better than a hype Jordan 1, but the Ultra Boost is better than that, and it looks the same! I mean...
Come on, hair!
Dal, we're just going to go in circles, okay?
Yeah, we are.
Sports Plus Life. Nice shoes. How much? Are you Sneaker Gail, too? Ed? He literally said, nice shoes. How much? What were these?
Those two retail
these
$220.
These look like an Ed shoe. These are a Sports Plus Life shoe, bro.
You think Ed wear those?
This is absolutely an Ed shoe.
I don't see Ed in that shoe.
This is an Ed shoe all day.
Ed is a generic New Balance basic shoe. He's not an Ultra 4D guy.
Doug.
He's not.
Doug.
Ed, by the way, how's COVID? You doing all right, man? Have you healed up? Is everything better?
Speaking of that, oh my gosh, did you see Khamzat Chimaev?
Yes.
Pulled out of the fight with Leon Edwards because the COVID was still affecting his lungs, and he said he didn't feel back to full strength.
Still not 100% when he got back in the gym.
Crazy.
Yeah, dude.
That shocked me a little bit.
I wasn't shocked because I felt like it probably had something to do with COVID still. Not that he still had it, but maybe a family member, that kind of thing. So I knew it stemmed probably around that. But when it was like, yo, I'm still not good, I was shocked, but I was like, same with Myles Garrett. Same with Lamar Jackson. Same with a lot of these fools that have had it, man. They're all still not 100%. And these are pristine athletes. These are the luxury cars.
Mm-hmm.
What do you used to say? The luxury cars?
The Lamborghinis.
The Lamborghinis.
The Ferraris.
There you go. There you go.
Yeah, luxury sleds, bro. They are. They are. And they're still getting affected by COVID. That surprised me a lot, though. I was very shocked to see that, to hear that, and I guess maybe just because it's him too, and you always think, you think Khamzat Chimaev, you think smash, you think I'll fight anybody, anytime, next week, tomorrow, tonight, mm-hmm. just the way he's been, and to see him get buckled like that,
yeah,
it was just, it really blew my mind a little bit. Ed says he's all good.
Good, man.
Chonerman, $5 in the super chat. Thank you, bro. If you want to pitch in for the going away fund, just search MUP going away gift last spam from me. That's his super chat there. Thank you, Connor.
Hey, you That's know, nice we've been doing good at shots.
You know, so. What's funny too? That's actually coming really handy because we're going to be paying some extra months on this studio.
Everybody's going to drop off Patreon because we're not going to have anything to offer.
Right. So we're just like literally going to be coming out of pocket on the stud.
Yeah. And not using it.
You gotta love it.
We had such great plans coming into 2021, and then they were all
2020,
just
2020
or 2020. Yeah,
yeah.
Hey, here
so
go.
Funny. Should we get it?
Shoot that shit. See what you got.
The pinky ring is heavy though. It is heavy though, and the jacket is tight though. This is almost fat guy in a little coat. Like
you might have to pull out of the shot. You might have to Chimaev it. Oh, you better pull out the shot.
Oh man, it was. It was really close.
With all your restrictions, that was a pretty good shot.
Damn it.
It's a pretty good shot.
Now we got one more. Someone else super chatted earlier, so that's for you. You need to throw one up there too, please. But to close out the convo on the 4Ds, I'm out, but Ed's in. Ed's very excited. Gosh, this is totally an Ed shoe. Yeah. Ed does have a couple. He has a couple pairs of Adidas. That's why I can see him wearing these. He has a couple pairs. Yeah.
I've never seen him in Adidas. I think that's why I haven't.
Really?
I think I've just seen him.
But he's a running shoe guy.
Is
he's
he?
Like a, yeah, okay. I could see Ed being like a Roshi guy, being an Ultra Boost guy. I think he has a Nike Runner. Mm. He has, what's that one that came out with the crazy netting all around the outside?
The D-Rupt.
He's got the D-Rupt. He got him on super sale, I think.
Oh, the D-Rupt is awful. Okay. Then shit looked like looked like pantyhose over where you would have boost.
Mm.
It's not good.
I never thought about that.
Like fishnet, you know, fishnet pantyhose.
Wow, I never thought about it that way.
Those gross me out.
But yeah, I remember him having the D-Rups at a point in time. I remember, he's been in the game a little bit. Damn it, Black Press tried to repost the link and you can't approve it. It just says error.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
In the chat. Yeah, I was telling Choner that earlier. You can't post like any links in here. It doesn't even let us approve them. It's pretty crazy. Neighborhood. Hey. Go ahead.
Yeah, what does he say?
I'm never shocked about Dow's purchases. Not after the Billie Eilish tea, cop.
That's right.
John King, you still got that Billie Eilish tea that Dow convinced you to cop?
Dude, guess what I did with the Billie Eilish tea?
He probably gave it to one of his kids for Christmas. He was like, here you go.
There you go. Here, take this. Dude, I got rid of mine and a lot of Travis Scott merch that was either too big, too small, because we know how shitty that stuff was, right? Back in the early days.
Yeah.
Dude, I took it to Culture Street. And they cashed me out for all that shit.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
At recently at Park Meadows or before?
At the new Park Meadows location.
Wow.
Yeah, they cashed me out, dog. Offered me great value,
to be
honest. Yeah.
Good cats over there.
So I took a little bit of store credit and a little bit of cash, no doubt. That being said, let me give somebody a little bit of credit. Connor Terry who's actually been DMing me quite often here, just saying, hey, man, super happy for you guys, super proud of you guys. I've been following you since TTF's early vlogs. I just want to give this guy some shine, man. Hey, Connor, we really appreciate you, man. Be safe getting back to Texas. It sounds like he drove here for a skiing adventure.
Over
this holiday weekend. So he's driving back today. So right. Safe trip, man. And thanks for tuning in, bro.
Yeah, I just DMing him back this morning.
He's a good guy, man.
He's been following since the old school vlog. Said he was going to try to call in today, too. So we'll open up the lines here in a few minutes.
Hopefully we can hear
from
him.
What else do we have?
You want me to shoot this shit or what?
Oh, yeah. Go ahead. Sorry.
Who was this for?
This was the very first super chat we had of the show. And it was for Jason Ramirez. That's right.
Appreciate you.
Oh,
was that a swish?
Cash is in.
Was that? I mean,
nice job,
man. Feeling good.
Good shit, Dal. John Pissed. Or John King. John Pissed.
John Pissed.
I still haven't fucking sold that shit in all caps. I'm so pissed. Worst $14 I ever spent. Nice job, Dal.
$14, man. I feel for him, you know?
Can't believe he did that. Probably better off using it as a chamois to wipe down your caddy after the car wash guy.
Yeah, I would say.
That's probably a better move there. I mean, I think it can have value.
Yeah, get you some of that rim shine spray. Put that, spray that on your rims, dude, and use the Billie Eilish tee.
The Armor All?
Yeah, dude, that little I think it's called Black Magic, the tire magic or something.
Oh, yeah.
Something like that.
Yeah.
Use that shit.
Thomas Yee, $10 in the super chat. What up, Yee?
Holy shit. Oh, I'm going to have to grab that.
The ball, is it out?
Yeah, it's
out of range.
I'm going to let you redeem yourself here.
Do we have anything more for the sneaker stuff or no? Are we all out?
I don't.
Nothing more.
I know. Way to end the show. I only have two pairs. You know what I was waiting for today and I got an update? It's
what?
Actually it's in transit to the house because it starts with UPS and then UPS does a handoff to USPS. Dude, my Travis Scott Nerf Blaster will be here today, finally.
I didn't even get shipping, but I'm happy for you. Thank you.
Oh, but you ain't got shit yet?
I don't have the shipping for mine, no.
You ain't got shit on shipping?
No.
So yeah, we'll have that, but...
It'd be cool if it just shows up, but I'm kind of nervous.
I couldn't have it for our last episode, unfortunately.
Wow.
Dude, resale has tanked. A few months ago, those were going for $300, $250.
Not anymore?
Now they're like $80. 60, 70.
Wow.
Probably not even retail anymore. I don't even know what we spent. I'd have to look back.
That was in April, yeah. All right, I'm going to shoot this. Get the calling ready.
Oh, you want to get the calling ready?
And throw out the number. That way we can just start getting people queued up, whatever. Our call screener will see if you're on-air material. Eli.
See if fools are worth it.
UPS, USPS handoff is a bunch of BS.
True.
I haven't had that happen to me, have you?
Yes.
What's going on?
Well, it happens a lot. I think it's all with Travis Scott merch. That's the only one I've ever had.
Oh, only with Travis Scott merch.
Well, that I've dealt
Damn
with.
It.
I think it's I think it happens with, oh, dude, my bread Yeezys and the 500s. Dude, they outsourced. Typically, Adidas.com always is FedEx. But, dude, they use this Pitney and Bowes company. And then Pitney and Bowes ended up giving it to USPS. It was, dude, what a dog shit show. Eli, I am with you, man. I've now had that with Travis Scott merch and with Adidas.com over the holidays. It's not
weird.
Good.
All right. I know they're backed up. I had
awful.
To finish out sneakers here, I had I had to go cop. I paid resale on Go. I feel like I got a great price, $270, $273 for the Jordan 1 Midnight Navies. Had to get them. Was not really mad when I missed out. I was kind of like, yeah, whatever. And then as I had this GOAT credit and as I've had a couple other pairs sell, I'm like, you are a moron. You wear so much navy. I love navy. One of my favorite colors. Why would I don't have any navy Jordan 1s. I have the Georgetown 11 Lows, which are a really dope navy and gray. I have some shit with some navy on it, some Michigan joints, the Dunk from Above Jordan 4. But I don't have any navy Jordan 1s. I don't have anything. Navy Jordan 1. So the Midnight Navies were a must for me. Had to go back and pick them up. And that's my last pickup of the year. Won't be here in time. But speaking of backed up, these shipped out from GOAT. I just got the notification that they shipped out from GOAT on Tuesday. and they will not be here until next week, like Wednesday or Thursday, I think. So over a week from when I got the shipping notification. So everything is just backed up like crazy. Let's see here. TTF, my FM2 skates still didn't land. Ordered on 12/13. Package hasn't moved at all. Below not good. Dirty DJ, you bought him a...
Below not good.
You bought him... Did you buy him from the... Directly from GOT, the skate brand? Or did you buy him from like Roller Warehouse or some other third party or whatever? Because I bought mine directly from GOT and they were a little delayed, but I ended up getting them, obviously. Everything was cool, but that sucks, dude.
Yeah, no doubt.
If it's directly from God's, my shit was in a weird spot too for a while, and they were a little weird, but they did get here. So if it's from them, I wouldn't be too worried. But if it's Roller Warehouse or one of those places, you got to reach out to their customer service or something.
All right, real quick, while you're still talking here, our lines are open. So, and by our lines, I mean our line is open. That is 720-669-6017. Feel free to call in. We'll take your calls.
There you go. You can talk about whatever you guys want to talk about. We're going to get into our top five sneaker pickups of the week, of the year, sorry. and we'll probably do that at the end of the show. So, you guys want to run down any topics, you have any questions, anything like that, but that's something we will get into if that was part of your questioning. So I just want to let you know that. Some of the shit that happened this year, bro, I was going through a list, and I was just trying to remember off the top of my head. But when you look through these lists, you really forget all the wild shit that happened. At number one, I mean, on my mind, the thing that, what's number one for you? It just pops into your mind. Are you cooking some shit up still?
Oh, I was just going to put the phone number in our...
Oh, you can. Go ahead. Do that first.
Yeah, okay.
But yeah, if you want to call in, bring up any events that maybe we're missing or... some of the your favorite moments, good and bad. I think there were, even though, 2020 and... has this crazy rap, and obviously it was a wild ass year and a lot of bad shit for a lot of people. There were still silver linings. There were still good things. And I think for me personally, a lot of the stuff that was good was in this year was self kind of reflection, self-realization, growth, being trapped in the crib with my girl, having to work on things, having to figure shit out. Our relationship has just grown so much this year. And through all of it, actually, I guess the past couple of years, but really this year, I had a dog. I didn't have a dog last year. I got a dog at the end of last year going into this year. That was a whole new experience. Just having something that loves you no matter, every day, the same energy, the same love. I never thought that Benny would bring me the joy that he does. He brings me frustration, but he brings me so much joy too. And I think that's exactly like a kid or anything else. That's what happens when you're taking care of something. This is all new for me. As a guy that went through life like not for sure knowing if I was going to ever have kids, not really like, moved out the crib at 18, never looked back, kind of no real concrete family right there all the time, right. Like no safety net, I guess. I don't know. No real, just kind of moving through as by myself, if you will. This is really teaching me, and obviously you have family members you love, you have family, people you love and care about, but not on a close level like this. This has really taught me a different love and a different appreciation. The dog, my girl, all this stuff has been a lot. It's been a lot of learning for me, and it's been good. It's been positive learning. It's been good things that are going to help me become better in the future that have made me look at like my future differently than I maybe did before. Just going into certain years, being older, appreciating different things. So that's a lot of the good stuff that's happened for me personally in 2020. It's been a lot of those kind of things for me. Even though all the stories and the year and a lot of the stuff wasn't good on that aspect of things.
Right.
So
I'm right there with you. For me, the relationship obviously has been taxed by a lot of things about me kind of skipping out on some of my identities, trying a different career, going through counseling with Robin, and then the health issues. So for me, it's really just kind of trying to be more grateful for a lot of things, right? Gratitude has obviously been really in the forefront of my thinking, being thankful for what I do have, being thankful for the days that I'm given, being thankful for family, being thankful for a relationship, and for Robin really doing a great job taking care of us and facilitating some of the home stuff as I kind of venture out and kind of being the rock, right? Not within just our relationship, but also being the rock if, hey, if I didn't have enough to pay a certain bill or whatever, you know, she's got our back. And that's hard to let happen as a man. And there was good thing I sold my house. There's just been everything that has been comfortable and good in my life and consistent. I've really just kind of pulled the carpet underneath all those things and really ventured out. And even as bad as 2020 was, the life lessons and the things that I learned from making some of these decisions or lack of committing to decisions has been monumental. And I just feel stronger and more well-equipped, obviously, going into 2021. You know, I feel like I can handle even greater things than what we dealt with through a global pandemic, through people losing their jobs, through friends and family not being able to see them. You know, all this different technology that we've had to use to be able to, you know, to chat with people and to keep in touch with people. I just feel like I have more tools in the tool bag, you know, going into the new year. That's kind of where I'm at.
What's the number one story you think of this year when you just think of stories, good or bad? Or what's the number one thing you think of this year that you just can't believe happened?
The number one.
Is it the virus? Is it something else?
Yeah, I mean, obviously the virus, but I feel like just the deaths in general. I feel like whether it's music, I used to be a big music guy. We've had a lot of musicians, infamous musicians, pass this year. I mean, Eddie Van Halen obviously being one of them, Neil Peart from Rush. I mean, the list goes on. There's just been so many great people that were a part of my childhood that are a part of my life now that we've lost. So I think the year of loss, for sure, whether it's people, jobs, losing people to death, and then obviously the COVID, those are kind of my top three, you know?
Yeah, the for me, it's Kobe. Like, just the, mm-hmm. that was just so shocking. Like, yeah. That was more than anything, the pandemic, anything else, just Kobe. Just was not expecting that. That was even before COVID really got crazy.
And, was.
Oh man, that's number one for me. It just right away, like, that's the number one thing I think about this year. And I'm like, gosh, it's like, wow, that did happen this year. It feels like longer, but then it doesn't feel like longer. And I'm just spun up in this like confusion when I think about that whole time and what mm-hmm. went on, and it makes it worse with Gigi there. Yeah. It's just so unreal. The way that he went out, we're like, so gosh, dude, a guy like that to go out. I go out like that, who cares? I die on the freeway, mm-hmm. helicopter, you know, whatever. Like, but a guy like that to go out like that, it just sucks, bro. And it just makes you really think. We can all go, like we kind of talked about last show, we can all go out anytime. We can all, and that's why it's like, all right, you got to really, at some point, you got to really start, instead of like living for tomorrow all the time, or like, I'll get to it kind of shit, you really got to start hammering out goals and really start knocking these things down if you want to level up. And falls right in line with the theme of what we're doing with this show and everything moving forward into the new year.
It's true.
You got to start taking action at some point. Mm-hmm. And that's what that really reminds me of, you know. It's just him and his daughter, bro. Just can't imagine for the wife, the family still. Yeah. And then to have that happen to the family, and then they had to go through what's been the rest of this year. Ugh. Mm-hmm. Jeez, just your heart breaks for those kind of people, or for those people. Sorry, Alex Trebek's death.
Yeah,
that's another one.
A big one.
Talking about that, we talked about Ed. Chadwick Boseman, dude.
Yeah.
My gosh.
How he was actually—I don't want to say hiding, but he was hiding his disease that was literally killing him in front of us, and just so we didn't have to worry about him, and just so we. Like, you talk about the integrity of a man, you know, somebody who doesn't want to let out his pain and wants to just only help cancer patients. You saw him in the hospitals, dude, going to all the young kids, visiting all these young kids and trying to inspire. I mean, dude, I remember, and I feel bad about it now, but we're honest here, right? Remember when we talked about the dunk contest? And I was like, yo, dude, what is Chadwick Boseman? Like, he just seems like he's, like, why is he there? He's not energetic, like... He just seems weird. Something seems off. He doesn't look
I
right.
You talking about that, yeah.
He almost looks like his cheeks were sunken in. And who am I? Like, I don't see Chadwick on the daily. Like, but I just know what I know in my head. I mean, I watched all the Black Panthers, like, you know, and I just said, man, something ain't right with
wasn't
that guy.
Wasn't him, right?
He's not tuned in. I don't know what the hell's going on with him, but that's weird to me. And at that time, he was obviously, you know, stage 4 and 5 of his cancer, dude. Like, this was months before it actually took him away from us.
Yeah.
And man, that was difficult for me. And, you know, once I found out that obviously he passed, I thought about that and how I spoke about those things. And to me, it sounded negative because I was giving myself a hard time, but it wasn't. I was just, here's what I saw and something wasn't right. But, you know, when he did pass, I was just like, damn, I shouldn't. I feel bad now. But,
right. Yeah, know, it could be tough.
I don't know. You know,
it can be tough for sure.
But hey, we've got a couple callers here. One's been waiting for almost 10 minutes here. Let's bring in a caller.
Yeah.
What do you say?
Yeah, yeah.
Yo, who do we have on the air?
Well, how's it going, guys?
Oh, T-Buck, what
T-Buck?
Up?
T-Buck?
You got to turn up your volume on your phone, Dow. Just put it all the way to the max.
Got my phone?
No,
I
got
you,
Dow. Yeah. All right,
I'm driving down I-25, so it's not like I was like really waiting on anything like crazy or something.
Oh, hey, at least you're driving.
But, I just wanted to. I got the Bluetooth in, eyes are on the road, like 100% safety right here.
Good, man, good.
But I just wanted to thank you guys for the years of entertainment. All the sports advice, everything. It's just been hilarity and good times, feeling like I know you guys. I actually met Thomas once at a Nuggets game, and that's how I started following the cast. Was one of his buddies that used to work at Certified knew one of my buddies at BMW, and we all went to a Nuggets game together, and he introduced himself to me, and he's like, I thought it was going to rain that day, so I wore Vans to the game, and I had this huge North Face jacket that I slipped on when we walked out of the exit. And I was talking to Thomas, and I was like, yeah, man, I love Ultra Boost. He's like, yeah, probably whatever, this dork's wearing Vans. And I, like, slide on this North Face jacket, and he goes, hey, man, that's pretty sleek. Is that real? Is that a Supreme collab? And I was like, no, it's just an Agronac pullover, you know, just a cool little jacket. And ever since then, like, I looked up kind of Thomas online and stuff and then started following the cast. I didn't know you guys were, like, locals and, like, so into sports and stuff. And I just kept listening ever since.
Dude, that's such a sick story because I remember like little pieces of that briefly. Like, I definitely remember that game. I remember going with Joey. I remember all that stuff. But I just remember pieces of that very, very briefly. And that's so cool that that's how you started following
the
show.
Back in the day, and I was like, oh man, this guy's on top of it. Like, I wish I would have found out about him earlier, kind of thing. And then, I remember you were wearing like black cement threes. I have this like trefoil Adidas Iverson jersey from like, I don't know, my senior year in high school, it's like 07. And we were both just like, kind of like, hey man, cool fit. Hey man, cool fit. And then, I just kind of like, I was like, who is this guy? And
that's
then I found out about the podcast. And I just kept watching you guys because I found it thoroughly entertaining.
That's really dope, man. That's I was probably wearing this black bomber that I have all the time and just a black fit with some black cement threes, dude. Yeah.
You fools were having a fit off.
Just clean. Yeah.
That's what's up.
Hey, I
was wearing Vans. I thought it was gonna rain.
you weren't taking the heat outside. I don't blame you.
But the North Face jacket
was what caught my eye. Never. And then like I'm telling this guy that I like Ultra Boost and stuff, and I'm like wearing Vans and a North Face jacket to a Nuggets game. Probably wasn't a good impression, but hey, it happened.
No, dude, I think the jacket was super, super ill. That's what initially had caught my eye, man. I'm never the guy that's like too cool to tell somebody if I like
got
some
it from,
shit. Like,
I got it from that snowboard shop on clearance because it was like the last one in a 2X, that snowboard shop on 7th and Lincoln, like Evo or whatever.
Oh, yeah, that new shop on the corner, yeah. Dude,
yeah, I got it for like $210.
Oh, yeah, dude.
And I just like thought it was the ultimate steal, so I just like grabbed it, and everyone always is like, hey, man, cool jacket.
Yeah, dude.
Still have it.
I thought about working at Evo for a little bit, man. That's a great culture down there. It's a cool store. I didn't want to really make that commute from Parker. Obviously, everybody, you know, that's local here knows that Parker is way south.
Parker, that's rough.
Yeah, dog. So like I just couldn't do that. But I was trying to be a sales manager down there.
Where's your guys' studio at?
So we're
So
we're in Aurora. So we're like off of 225 and 6th Avenue. You know, when you take 225 to get to 70, so, you know, that's
there's like a bunch of, if you're on 225.
And then, Dow, you used to work at Certified too, right?
I didn't know. I just did the cast. That was Thomas that actually worked at Certified, him and Stringer. And I would just commute over there 2 days a week to do the cast out of that glass house.
Okay. Yeah, because dog, I've never had the opportunity of running into you, I don't think, but that's totally how I met Thomas, and then I guess how I became a listener.
That's tight, crazy, man. Well, it's a small world.
Yeah, we got to get together, man. After this COVID thing, obviously we've been talking about it in the chat.
I'm sure if Thomas still talks to Joey, he lives with one of my buddies from high school.
Oh, sick.
I'm sure we'll all run into each other. I just saw Joey. I gave them their Christmas tree for their little place or whatever.
Nice.
Over there on the golf course in Littleton.
Mm-hmm. Nice, man.
Dude, Joey's the nicest guy you'll ever meet. Great nicest guy.
Yep. Absolutely.
That's for sure.
Well, T-Buck, thanks for listening, bro, thanks for calling in. Guys.
Yeah, thanks for everything, guys. I mean, all the hours of entertainment can't be counted. You guys are the best. We'll see you soon.
Absolutely, brother.
Appreciate it, man.
Yeah, no doubt.
All right, the number 720-669-6017 if you want to call into the show. The other thing I was going to say too, yeah, make sure you guys are following on Twitter at OMG It's TTF at Dal Palantonio or on the gram. Twitter's easier to go back and forth, I feel like, with people. So if you want to interact more, it's easier. Just so we can all stay in touch. And Misha said on the last episode, hit him up about the info for Nonstop Cop in the Discord. Mm-hmm. I'll be throwing bets in there, here and there. If you guys are interested in betting info, I'll be throwing betting info in there. There's a ton of different sneaker info, all that stuff. So if you're interested in joining, just hit up Misha and he'll give you all the details on that Discord and everything there. He was talking about getting me and you both in there with some most underrated shit. So
that'd be dope.
I got to have a convo with him here this upcoming week as well after the holidays. $10 in the super chat from John King.
Oh, wow.
Follow your boy on all the socials. This will be my final donation, and that's sad. Thanks to Dal and TTF, the first and only non-asterisk year fantasy champ. I tried to give you a gunshot on top of it, John King, but we got the audio cord plugged into the phone. You know we do it, bootleg. My bad. Good shit, though.
Let me shoot this one here. And then we can take another caller. Cool. Actually, while I'm shooting this, is there any other comments that you want to get out before we take another call?
Neighborhood. Wish Uncle Jim called. I thought you had it. My man Josh Cheek catching the final cast. What up, Josh? How you doing, bro? Another guy I need to reach out to.
Good guy.
I think the first issue or the first thing should be his dick issue from John King. Dal Palantonio. That should be the first thing you think about.
Yes, the dick issue.
Funny. All right. Go ahead. Get the next one on.
All right, we got a 609 area code for you fools. Let's see what we got. All right, sorry about that wait. Who do we have?
Hey, am I on?
You are on.
Yo, this is Jeff, a.k.a. Dirty DJ. What's up, fellas?
Dirty DJ. What's good, bro? Welcome to the show.
Nah, man. Thanks, guys. I just wanted to call in, say congrats for all the years, and for all the entertainment value, passing those Monday blues. Man. Look forward to the cast for years, man.
I fucking love that.
Appreciate
Philly
all you guys
accent.
Done for us in the community. Yeah.
I love that Philly accent. Passing the I don't even know what you said, bro. I'm fucking dying. I love it. I love it. Matty Betts talks like that too.
South Jersey, man. South Jersey. You remember I caught up with you at that
Philly tattoo
convention.
Yeah, dude, exactly. Yeah, we met up there, dude. I wish we had more time to kick it. Yeah, so exhausted, bro. Oh my god.
Yeah, it was cool. I was getting some work done too, so.
Yeah, I remember that. He was at the convention getting work done.
You happened to be there, and I just swung through real quick just to say I appreciate it. I think that was when you were just doing the vlogs and stuff too. But,
it was, bro.
Way back in the day, man.
We hadn't even started the cast yet, I don't think, at that point.
Yeah.
Which is crazy.
God, I know, dude. We ramped up so fast. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. August of 2018, right after the New York trip, it was on.
Right before football season.
Yep.
Yeah. Bam. Man, that's for sure. Dirty, you got any new ink lately?
No new ink, man. COVID put the end to that, man. I got to finish this back piece. I was supposed to finish it last spring, and then COVID hit.
Yeah, for sure, for sure.
About one more 8-hour session.
Yeah, no doubt. How's the weight room that you got built, man? Is it all rogued out and ready
to
go?
It's good, man. It's good. It's just I lost motivation the last few weeks since the wife got sick to go down there and sling the iron. But I'll get back until it's here soon. It's a way of life for me, just like Fail Beast.
Yeah.
I just wanted to call in, wish you guys the best. Wanted to call in, wish you guys the best in your new endeavors. And I'll stay in touch with your socials, man. Keep killing the game, guys.
Yo, Dirty, are you gonna skate those skates?
Oh, for sure, bro. My wife was making fun of me, said I haven't skated in 10 years, so I might take some L's, but it'll be worth it.
Oh, I'm so pumped. T-Mobile was when we were starting to like skate, he sent me some videos busting his ass. He's like, dude, I hurt my wrist. My kids are out here.
I caught a couple of them that he. I caught a couple of him that he put up there, but
be careful,
I'm old,
bro.
Man. I'm just turned 40 this year, so I got to be careful with these old bones, man.
Yeah, but shit, even if you got to put on some wrist guards and some knee pads and shit, don't be too proud, bro. I just went and rode mine at the park for the first time the other day, and I rode the stock frames that they came equipped with. Did you get them as a complete set, or did you just get them as boot only?
Yeah, the complete package, how they came. Yep.
I wish I would have got boot only, because use the stock frames. I don't ride anti-rocker normally. I don't ride flat. I ride with the ground control Formula Ones, where they just have the huge H block in the middle that were on those Rashard Johnsons, that red pair I have. So dude, I just took that whole frame setup off and put it on the gods, and now they're just so much better. On those gods, when you first put them on, bro, number one, the ankle is hella tight. You gotta struggle to get them bitches on. Number two, they lean back crazy style. And I don't know if that's just because I'm used to coming from USDs, but they lean back like crazy, and I almost busted my ass. And I feel really comfortable on skates. I'm a guy that's very comfortable, been in, you know, skating on and off here and there, not taking too long of a break. And bro, I felt like I was legit on ice, like on skates a little bit. Like I was like, whoa, like, well, rocking me backwards.
That doesn't bode well for me then, man, because I haven't rode skates since my K2 Fat Bobs like Dal had.
Oh, see, the Fat Bobs.
And maybe this is a good thing, maybe it's a bad thing, I'm not sure, but maybe it was me coming from USDs. My USDs, it felt like they rocked me forward a little bit. I sat forward on the skates. So I took the frame setup off the ground control frames I had, and that's the company that makes the frame set, Ground Control, and I put those on the gods, and they're money now, dude, money. I did the first kink rail on them at the skate park the other day, hit some ledges. I'm feeling good.
Well, I'm gonna just cruise around the neighborhood.
Yeah, don't
them.
Get
I'm not
too
gonna
crazy.
Do anything crazy.
Make a little P-rail maybe, put it into some grass, and you can kind of grind into the grass a little bit, get back. Don't do like T-Mobile.
Get the practice back. I went to put on those K2s, and the whole straps, everything just disintegrated, dude. I'm like, not to use these.
Like some 90s Jordan 5s, and I just put them on, and the sole just blows out.
Yep, that's how it was, man. But yeah, good luck, guys, and I'll stay in touch with you guys on socials, man.
Appreciate it, Dirty.
Thanks, Dirty.
All right, man. Later, guys.
Later. Love that guy. Dirty
Great
DJ.
Guy.
All right, who we got next? We're just going to be banging calls as long as there's calls.
Might as well do it. Let's see. We've got a 970 number. Don't know what to expect here. All right, you're on the air. Who do we have?
Hey, guys.
Hey!
Long-time listener, first-time caller.
I can tell you're a first-time caller. Are you eating on the air, Ed?
Oh, yeah, I'm definitely eating.
I could tell.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's
it
what...
It took forever, so I had to fucking eat something. I was going to starve to death.
Jeez.
I'm just glad you got your appetite back, man. Can you taste the food, Ed?
Oh, I was only able to taste.
He said he never lost it.
Oh, really? He never lost it?
No,
he just had the cough, right?
I would have started eating vegetables.
Oh, yeah, no shit.
He was feeling...
Yeah, all I had was the cough.
Cough, and he was like achy. He could have said he couldn't move, like wiped him out for the weekend, but he didn't lose taste and smell. That's what we were talking about the other show. It was just such a weird, why do some people get certain shit? Like, it's all very odd.
Yeah.
It's all very strange. Anyways, Ed.
I don't know. Maybe I'll catch that new strain and we'll see what happens.
You're trying to get the new one? Is that way you get all the bases covered?
Yeah, we'll see. It's great records over here, huh?
Yeah, I guess Colorado was the first to have that in the States, supposedly. That's what they say. So, Colorado, winning yet again.
Yeah, just straight dubs everywhere.
What do you think of Hamzat Shemaev on the COVID shit. Isn't that crazy news? Were you shocked, as shocked as I was?
Isn't that crazy? Yeah, I mean, I don't know. Nothing shocks me anymore when it comes to this shit. But it's like, you know, it's crazy. We talked about it last time, how I don't have those residual effects that he has. You know, not my lungs. I mean, I'm also not an athlete either, but I mean, he's a super athlete. And this thing just debilitated him. He can't even couldn't train right. He couldn't make the comeback either, a quick turnaround like they thought a lot of athletes would. It just puts you down. It's pretty crazy to think about that. Someone like me, as an athlete that I am, I survive and I feel fine, you know?
Yeah.
Crazy.
That's wild shit.
That is crazy.
Yeah, I don't know how. I don't know.
Yeah, it's crazy, but
no rhyme or reason to it either. You don't know. You don't know what strain you're gonna get, how bad you're gonna get it, what effects you're gonna get.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. You never know. But yeah, I just wanted to call in, say my goodbyes because I probably never see you guys again. And just kidding. No, I just want to say goodbye. To the cast. You guys have done a great job. I've always looked up to you guys. Always watched you guys. Obviously, I've been on the show plenty of times, so I haven't gotten a free shirt. And yeah, no, I don't look at this as a goodbye. I know when you guys will be back. It's 2020. You guys got other goals, obviously different priorities, but I feel like you guys will be back for sure, and I'll be there for it 100%.
Man, that means a lot, Ed. Man, appreciate that, man. You're a great guy, and shit. Follow Sports Plus Life. You know what? Fill your life with what we are missing. What you're missing out with us, fill it in with some Sports Plus Life. Ed, give us the plug.
Follow me at Sports Plus Life, Instagram and Twitter. MRAKACO, Instagram and Twitter. You'll find me. I'm blowing up on Twitter because last night, Oklahoma Sooners just stomped Florida Gators last night.
Wow.
And I'm over popping memes, and I'm popping off with the memes.
Mm. Boomer Sooner.
So your meme game's fire. So you're getting a bunch of followers from your memes.
Yeah,
what's going on.
Translate to followers 2021.
I like it.
What about Rattler? Are you in on that guy for the future of Oklahoma football?
Dude, yeah, of course I'm in on that guy. Yeah, I think he leads the. I want to say they said last night he leads the league in touchdown passes, or leads the nation in touchdown passes from a quarterback.
Mm-hmm.
And he's a true, pretty much a true freshman.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Bright future for the kid, and I think. And I think he's still a baby, so I think he might get taller, too. He's only, 18, 19 years old. I mean, I think he's only going to get taller, which is pretty crazy to think about, right? Hmm. You know, you see these guys, and sometimes they'll just balloon up 3-4 inches over the summer, and then bam, you got a whole different – you have a Patrick Mahomes on your hand.
Right, mm-hmm. Right. Yeah, I think it's going to be
– who knows?
I think it's going to be real, real interesting. It's going to be fun, too, see those cats.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, it'd be fun. We'll see. Hopefully next year is a little bit better year. There's more games played. And
I know.
More games canceled.
I know, dude. Choner didn't even do a bowl pick'em this year, did he? Remember a bowl tournament, how we always do?
Oh, yeah, he does. And I don't think he did.
Because we...
He's too busy putting up Christmas trees and shit.
We didn't do a March Madness tournament because obviously that got canceled. And then he didn't do a bowl tournament because there was no real shit going on, I guess. I don't know.
Yeah, just not enough games and just such an odd schedule and weird how it played out. So, yeah.
Weirdo shit.
Yeah, 2020 was weird, man. 2020 is really weird. I was kind of bouncing off what you guys said earlier. I mean, 2020, I mean that Kobe Bryant death, put me in such a weird state. It was ridiculous.
Mm-hmm.
I remember starting out the year when that happened, it put me in a weird, weird state. And I didn't want to do anything. I didn't want to. I mean, because the reason why it affected me so much is that no matter what you do, your life could be over. You know, no matter what happens, no matter how healthy you are, no matter, how good good health you are mentally, whatever, your life could just be taken away like that. And that also, it translated to me ramping up my podcast. I started doing things I've never done before. I started streaming. I just started doing a bunch of things I've never done before. I was like, this could be it for me. And especially now the way it ended this week with John Huber, a.k.a. Brody Lee, passing away from wrestling, if you guys know that.
I know.
It's ridiculous how much of an impact people like that make, and you don't even know about it. And so you could be, me streaming, me doing the podcast. I could be changing someone's life. Maybe they just need that extra smile. Mm-hmm. Maybe they just need that, that just, you know, a distraction from what they got going on. Mm-hmm. You know, you guys did that all year. You guys did a great job doing it. I'll take the torch. I'll take the baton, and I'll keep it from here until nice. You guys are ready to come back and do it.
I love it. Love it, man. Love it.
Ed, did you, speaking of passing away, Kevin Green, dude, what about that, bro? I know you and I, big wrestling fans. Kevin Green crossed over into wrestling.
Isn't that crazy?
54, was he?
Yeah, I remember that.
54 years old?
Crazy.
Yeah, it was 50-something, maybe 56. 50. I can't remember. Okay. But you remember he was part of that whole Lawrence Taylor entourage against Bam Bam Bigelow. That
absolutely.
Was it 10?
Yeah, dude. And then yeah. And then that's the thing. He got in like there, and then he went into WCW full-time with like Mongo McMichael during that whole era.
I think he was a better wrestler than McMichael.
Oh, dude, Mongo was the worst, bro. I didn't realize how bad Mongo was till I saw a clip a couple months ago. Oh, my gosh. Steve Mongo McMichael, former member of the Four Horsemen at that
Mongo
time.
McMichael Mondays.
Right. Can you believe how bad that guy was? But Kevin Green.
I didn't even realize he was that bad.
Yeah, he was terrible. But Kevin Green, dude, Kevin Green was such a legend. I'm going to let you get off the phone, and then I'll play this Kevin Green sound so you can hear it. I have a piece of sound from Kevin Green talking about hitting Bo Jackson, and it's just classic, dude. Mm. So, yeah, it's pretty fun.
Pretty
it's
tight.
Like a 30-second sound clip, so I'll play that in a minute when you get off the phone. But RIP to Kevin Green.
Hey,
as well.
I'm sick of you. I just want to say hi. I'm done with you guys right now. Yeah, it looks like you guys have equipment that you aren't going to use. So I'm going to have to hit you guys up and see what kind of donations I can get from you guys.
Yeah, keep it locked to the socials. We'll be auctioning off some studio gear.
All right, yeah. Well, I'll talk to you guys again. That's not going to be the last time. But, yeah. But congratulations. Hope you guys achieve your goals. And, you know, when COVID kicks rocks, we'll meet up again.
Love it.
Right on, Ed.
Take care, Ed.
Thanks, brother.
Yeah. And hey, Adam says what's up, too. Rizzle says what's up.
Riz, what's up, Texas fans, bud? I just gave him the horns down for Texas fans. Tell him to watch the TV in 3 minutes.
All right, guys, we'll hit you guys up. We'll see you guys.
All right, Ed, later.
Later, fool.
Oh, my gosh. Yeah, let me see if I can play this Kevin Green sound real quick. Kevin Green, if you don't know, Kevin Green's a legend. Just one of the baddest NFL. I don't even know if I think it was D-line linebacker hybrid. And he played for the Pittsburgh Steelers in his early days. Then he played for Carolina. Or did he play for Carolina? He coached at Carolina. I think he was coaching, and he headbutted a guy one time with no helmet on, and he didn't have a helmet on, and just busted his head open. He was just like, yeah, on the sidelines. Just a madman. Kevin Green
is insane. He had the long blonde hair, right?
Long blonde hair flowing out the helmet. Looked like a wrestler. Mm-hmm. Kevin Green. My earliest memories of Kevin Green were the Super Bowl that the Dallas Cowboys played Pittsburgh Steelers. I wanted the Steelers to win that Super Bowl so bad because I loved Kevin Green. Neil O'Donnell was the quarterback. The boss was in that bitch, Jerome Bettis. I remember watching that Super Bowl, and our power goes out in the first quarter. I'm probably 9 years old just losing my shit. Jeez. What is going on? We're going to have to go to the sports bar. My dad's like, hey, calm the fuck down, okay? I'm like, well, what are we doing here? It's the Super Bowl. Like, right. Is this only our house? Is this affecting the Mayberries across the street? What's the deal here? I got to go over there and see if we can watch the game. Like, same as I am here, just annoyed with the technology.
Yeah.
So the power goes out. Steelers end up getting their ass beat. They lose the Super Bowl. That was in the middle of the whole Cowboys dynasty. Troy Aikman, Michael Irvin, Emmitt Smith, you know, brought in Deion Sanders, sure. All that shit. So Kevin Green, this is some funny sound. This is from before he passed away, obviously. He's on the Jim Rome show, and he's talking about tackling Bo Jackson.
Oh, good Lord. It was a freight train, an absolute freight train. I'll never forget hitting that man as he was coming through the C gap with all I had, and he turned me around and just kept running. And then before I knew it, my position coach was all up in my grill, Romy, going, "You gotta hit him, Green! You gotta hit him!" And I'm taking an ass chewing, and I'm thinking, I hit that man as hard as I possibly could, and for nothing, he went right through me like I was nothing.
Oh man.
Dude, I just loved the passion. That shit just makes me smile, gives me goosebumps because I love Kevin Green so much. I'm so sad that he passed away in his 50s. And I just thought, I love the passion that he always had. I love the passion he had for the game. I love the passion he had for everything he did for life. Every time I had heard him, and I heard him on many different sports talk shows. I'd hear him on Radio Row a lot. I listened to sports talk for years. So during the Super Bowl, Radio Row, they'll have a bunch of different shows set up on Radio Row, and celebrities, different guests will be pumping products. So in exchange, they'll go sit down and give you an interview, and then they'll pump their product at the end of the thing. So you get a lot of unique guests, a lot of people you may not normally get. So Kevin Green was one of those guys that would just go, and he would just do classic interviews. Bill Romanowski, another guy that just an awesome former pro football player, because he's so passionate. You could tell that they got to where they got because they had a serious passion for that game. And RIP to Kevin Green, man. Let's take a next call.
Oh, man. Lines are heating up over here, my friend. All right. Let's get her going here.
Should we play the heaters intro? What's up?
Let's see here. I think I recognize this number, but I'm not totally for sure because we just don't, you know, we don't memorize. We don't memorize a lot of lines here. Hey, you're on the air. Who do we got?
Hi.
Hello.
Oh, hello. Well, you better give yourself a...
This call thing is super professional. I'm sad that it's the last podcast, but I felt like... This is Robin, by the way.
Oh, hey, Robin. How you doing?
Welcome.
I felt like I had to call, and this was my only opportunity to prove that my voice is only like 60% as annoying as Dallas's impressions of it are.
Oh,
wow.
I feel like... I'm glad you called in, because I feel like I get... I'm not around you as much, Robin, so I'm around Dallas all the time. And then all of a sudden, I start doing the impression of you. I'm doing the Dallas's impression because I don't know the real you enough, like the real voice. I'm not around it every day in and day out like that. Right. Yeah, COVID. Yeah, this year's made it really rough because I'm only around him. So that's all I get is the impressions.
It's only Dallas's impression of me this year. But it's probably somewhat accurate, but I think he stretches it just a little bit. It's another Dallas-ism that we've all grown to love.
Do the impression, Dal, one time for the one time.
Shit, man. Then I got to go back home and deal with that shit. You know what I mean? All right. Hey, babe. What's up? How we doing today? Is that pretty good?
Ew.
Maybe you do the impression better. Ew.
I think you did like too low. Like you made it sound like she just woke up. Like I could get maybe I could see how she could get there.
Yeah.
I don't think that's her normal voice.
Right.
But if she just woke up, I could see how she could get to that point. I would say more like, Dallas has too many pairs of shoes right now.
That's pretty good.
That's about it.
That's pretty good.
That's about all I have.
Dallas.
Or did that sound
the exact
same?
You guys, I'm right here. I can hear you.
Oh. Gotcha. All right.
Sorry, Robin, you have the floor. I'm sorry.
Well, Robin, yes, you have the floor.
Well, I wanted to say thank you to all of the listeners. You know, I feel like the MUP family is part my family, too, because they actually know more about my personal life than my actual family does. But I just know there's been so much support, and what an incredible community that has been built here. And I just wanted to show some love on this last cast.
Well, I appreciate that, man.
Thank you so much, Robin. That means a lot. I know you've been listening to the show from the beginning. Thank you for allowing us to bring up all the personals. Thank you allowing us to be transparent with our audience. It makes the show better. I'm sure they appreciate it. They feel it. Yeah, I'm not very good at the thank yous, but that is what I can say. I know it's really been... I've appreciated it because I know it's not easy. It's not easy to do that, especially when you don't really have control. You know, you just get to watch the show and you're like, oh my God, that's not how it went down, Dallas. You know, so I appreciate your,
that is 100% what I'm thinking.
I got you.
Every time.
Yeah. That's exactly what our counseling sessions were every time. Hey babe, why don't you tell the counselor what happened last show? What happened this show? What happened the next show? That's a lot of what we dealt
yeah.
with. Yeah, for sure. Yeah. So Dallas, the loose cannon, there's no doubt about it, but I got good support at the house. So that's good news. So. We appreciate you, Robin. Thank you.
But I'm going to miss the cast, too. I couldn't usually catch it live. I was usually on a delay, but it provided me with a lot of entertainment as well. So I'm really, really, really bummed, but I get it, what needs to be done. So love and support for you guys and everybody else listening, and Happy New Year.
Well, thanks, babe. Appreciate it. Love you, and we'll see you a bit later.
Thank you, Robin. Happy New Year.
All right. Happy New Year. All right. Bye-bye.
Bye. Love it. Love to see it. That's funny. She called just to let people know Dallas's impressions are not really how she sounds. And after hearing that impression, I don't blame her.
Well, Del. Shit.
Because, I'm only doing what I get from you. I'm not, you know, she can't hold my feet to the fire. I'm not getting a real impression.
Oh, my feet have been on the fire.
Right,
my feet have been super litty. Trust me. What does the chat have to say? Chat have anything to say?
Holy shit, the internet's perfect today, John King. Exactly. I was just thinking the same thing. Why do we... Damn it.
Yeah. John King, don't ruin it here. You're going to have to throw more money in the chat.
Knock on the wood grain.
So we can pay more internet.
Our neighbors are going to think we're like knocking on over there.
Yeah, no shit.
Oh, well, they've dealt with the symbol this long. Fuck it. Over and over. The chat is loving Robin. Martin, who cut the onions? funny.
I'm not crying. You're crying.
Funny shit. Do we have any next?
Oh, yeah. This fool's been waiting for 28 minutes. Apologize. Let's get you on here. All right, you're on the air. Who do we got?
What's going on?
What's going on?
What's going on?
Uncle Jim.
Hey, I heard that there's some plexiglass laying around over there at the gyms.
Oh, wait, you sound like you're talking through a can and a string. Hold up. What did you say?
Well, I'm driving.
You're driving.
Hold on.
Let's not put... Well, your fight's okay now. It sounds all right. Sounds all right. We're getting through it.
I heard there's some plexiglass over there I can use.
Yeah, we're actually auctioning off the...
Are you guys done with that now? Because I got a window that's got a crack. I need that.
Stupid.
Yeah, I think we can donate that to you, Uncle Roselli, for sure.
Anything else laying around over there I can use? I never have enough stuff.
Nothing's laying around. We might be auctioning off some memorabilia from the studio, but nothing's laying around.
Oh, we're auctioning off. It's auction off memorabilia.
It's memorabilia. Oh. Do you just give memorabilia away? Oh. No, you auction it off. What do you mean? What are we talking about?
Oh, I didn't know it was auctioning off. So I got to put a bid in on the plexiglass?
Yeah, we'll get there. Follow us on the socials. Oh. We'll see what's going on.
Yeah. How's your Twitter going, Uncle Roselli?
You guys going to sign that for me, too?
Yeah,
what's going on, Dal?
Yo, what up, man? How's your Twitter following? How many followers you got? You got more than
I'm in Illinois right now.
Okay. Well, what about
I'm in Illinois on my way to St. Louis. There's no snow here at all. It's clear as a bell. It snowed once in New York and then only up by Western New York. Nothing in the middle too bad. I was up in Watkins Glen and Cooperstown.
Nice.
And down by Philly and all that stuff. Yeah, it's great.
That's good, man.
Everything's great. I'm eating Mia's cookies right now, so I'm wide awake.
Are you? Nice. I knew that care package would come in handy. Thought about not letting you take it. But
yeah, it came in real handy. I'm going to gain like 20 pounds.
Hey, she's going to love that you're eating them while you're driving. You're not getting too hungry.
Well, I got the dried apples are great. Those dried apples are great, except that I got a bone graft done on my jaw, bit into the dry apple and cut the sutures.
No.
That didn't go well.
Oh, shit.
Yeah,
I'm sorry.
I look like one of them wrestlers on TV that got punched, and I didn't even know I was bleeding until my significant friend said, "I taste blood."
Oh, shit. That's
he said, well, that's the end of the apples.
Oh, I'm sorry, man. Yeah, they're like these apple chips. They're just dehydrated apples.
Well, who knew I was gonna get a?
Yeah, and
who knew I was gonna get a bone graft? But it's been all good. So, anyways, that's it, huh? I come on the show, and 4 weeks later, it's over. Yeah.
Was it four?
Sorry.
Weeks? Was it the whole 4 weeks?
I didn't know it was the kiss of death.
Yeah, oh, I don't know if you've been listening to the past two episodes.
I worked at a car lot for 25 years, and when they fired me, they went under.
this has been your fault. The past couple episodes, we've just been roasting you. I don't know if you've been able to listen in when you've been out there with family. The past two episodes, we've basically just been blaming this whole thing on you, so.
No, I can't really hear that good, Zach.
The past two episodes, I don't know if you've heard... But we've been blaming us going out of business, the cast going off, on you. I'm not sure if you know.
Oh, did you?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Because it's the real reason. I mean, are you kidding me? You came on here.
Shit went in the toilet? Edgar.
No, Edgar. Edgar, according to Edgar, he's the best thing that ever happened to the cast. He boosted this cast to heights it's never seen, according to Ed.
You guys want to throw me a couple bucks, I'll go over to Eggers and get on his show, too. That'll be the end of him.
I like it.
Oh, good shit.
I can be the podcast hitman.
Yeah, the podcast nice. Hitman. Oh,
yeah.
Shit.
We'll pay you in plexiglass.
Good. We'll pay you in studio.
I just want to know what I'm going to do now. I got a freaking job, and I got to sit there and work for the whole hour and a half now.
Oh, geez, you and everybody else.
You guys do my hour and a half break twice a week.
I know. I hear this. You're preaching to the choir. It's the same thing we've been getting. You guys get me through the afternoons, man. You guys. I get it. I understand.
Right. I'm you're my too. Freaking break twice a week over there now.
Did you want me to stay here and say, you know what, guys? We're going to a premium. I got to gouge. We got to gouge it. $75 a month. We got to gouge every subscriber. That's all we could do. There's nothing else we could. You know what I mean? I'm sorry. I'm sorry. You guys are losing your afternoon entertainment.
I get it. Yeah, I guess I'll just have to. I don't know. I'll just sleep. Got to do something at work. All right. Well, I'm gonna hold everybody up. Are we going to get a Super Bowl or playoff picks anywhere? What is that going to be on that? Twitter or something?
What, you and me?
Oh, me and you?
Is that what you're saying? What are you asking? I'm sorry.
Are you gonna do a live any picks? Any more heaters anywhere?
Am I gonna do it or am I gonna do it with you?
On your chat? Oh no, just anybody on your chat. Are you gonna have it on your social media?
I'm not sure. I don't think
with everybody. Oh, you don't know, okay. Well, I won't hold you up anymore. Well, we'll miss you guys. That was a lot of fun.
I don't know what you're asking. I don't even understand. Like, you got to do better with the questions.
You almost scratched the surface. My dad was on the air 65 years. But, you know, it takes a while to get started.
That's pretty good. I mean.
Good times, though. Good times. It was fun.
That's what I'm sensing. So if you want to continue to do heaters, let's maybe just say, hey, would you like to continue doing heaters through the rest of the year? Instead of the backhanded shit way you just asked the question where no one can even understand what you're talking about.
I don't. I'm driving with the sun in my eyes with no sunglasses. I don't know what I'm doing. you want to keep doing heaters.
Are you still doing research?
Know.
Is your research up?
I need the franchise to text me that hotel we got in freaking Missouri because I want to stay there again.
Oh, okay. I'll look it up. I'll go through my records.
Yeah.
I'll figure it out.
All right, well, we'll miss you guys. Have a great time.
All right, Uncle
and,
Jim.
We'll catch you on the road. All right, Dad. All right, Zach. See ya.
Love you.
Later, Uncle.
Love you too. Bye.
Uncle Jim.
Great guy.
Oh, the best.
Man.
He's trying to keep the heater's momentum going. Brian Jackson said.
I don't blame
obviously.
Him.
Obviously.
I don't blame him.
But I asked him if he did his research, and then he goes on to something else. I don't know if he's doing his research. If you guys trust him, does he know that the Chiefs are favored this weekend? Did you guys know the Chiefs are favored this weekend? Neighborhood hit me up like, yo, what the hell's going on here?
Without Big Gun?
That's what I said. I was like, Pat Mahomes ain't playing.
That's weird.
Bunch of starters ain't playing.
Yeah.
They got it wrapped up. Big Ben, not playing.
Fitzmagic?
Spreads are going to be crazy this week because not a lot of guys
COVID-19.
Are playing.
COVID-19.
This is a week I would, this is the week we should take off heaters and then bring it back for the playoffs. But this week, if you're betting this week, I would really try to bet the games that have heart. You know the team needs to win to get in kind of playoff situations. And sometimes I'm not saying take all those teams because that can put a lot of pressure on you as a team. When you need to win and the other team doesn't necessarily need to win, the team that needs to win feels a lot of pressure. And oftentimes they don't play as well as the team that's loose and doesn't really care what happens. So you never know. That's why I'm saying week 17 in general, I'm probably staying away except for the live betting. Once I can see the game get underway, see how things are shaking out, if I see an opportunity to jump in and make a little money, that's where I'm going to try to pick my spots. But I'm not doing too many pregame bets unless it's player props on games that they really need to have it. More calls?
Yeah, we got one more.
All right.
Let's get her done. A little 303 individual here. Let's bring him on. Hello, sorry about the wait. You're on.
Hi, guys. It's Amberta.
Yeah, Amberta. What's going on?
Oh, I'm just hanging out, listening to Last Cast, laughing like crazy as usual.
Not crying, I hope.
How's it going there?
It's going good. I said, what? I hope you're not crying.
Not as much as last cast.
Last cast, you were crying a lot.
I was. I had to break out a new box of Kleenex, but now I've come to the realization that this is it.
A
little while.
Do you agree? Do you like the slow burn? So do you like a little bit of time to process it all and ride off a little instead of just ending it like a boom, shotgun day?
That's right. Hey, I just wanted to thank you guys and thank the family. Now I'm going to start.
Oh, no. Everything's okay. We're moving.
No,
into...
you guys have been great.
Aunt Berta.
I've enjoyed it so much. And I actually retired now, just like Uncle Jim. I don't know what I'm going to do on these 2 days, but I'll figure it out. I don't know if I'll make it for the reunion in Las Vegas. Probably couldn't keep up with everybody.
But, certainly you could.
Well, if anybody rolls through Colorado, Zach, you guys will have to hook up for a barbecue in the backyard. I'd like to cook up some food for you guys.
Wow, that That'd be awesome. Fun.
Yeah.
That would be very fun.
Be good times.
Yeah. And Dallas, if you want some guac, just hit me up. I'll make you some, okay?
Oh, man, the Aunt Berta guac goes hard for sure.
All her food.
I'm gonna definitely hit you up on that, Aunt Berta, for sure. Thank you for that, man. When we first got our studio, I think she got us that guac early. And, man, thanks for thinking of me, man. I am the guac king. There's no doubt about it.
Yep. So, and Zach, I'm glad you're wearing your ring. Are you rolling it all the time or is it just for the last cast?
It's a little heavy for, like, an everyday daily driver type of thing, but for the show, for this kind of stuff, it's great. You know, for the
good.
For what I'm doing here, it's amazing.
Goes, yeah, that's an amazing
glasses,
gift.
The chains,
and Berta, you killed that gift. That's that's probably one of the best gifts I've ever seen. That's really cool, man.
Well, good. And it was nice to hear Robin's voice now.
Oh, was it?
John King. Yep. Be good, John King.
Yeah, no
All
doubt.
Right, guys.
Aunt Berta, thank you so much for
thanks
for always listening and supporting all the stuff that I do all the time. Whether it's my concerts, not even rap concerts when I was doing big shit. Concerts back at like talent shows and stuff as when I was in school. I love you, Aunt Berta. Thank you for always putting up with me. Thanks for putting up with the way I am. Thanks for always supporting everything I do, no matter what. Always reaching out to lend a helping hand, and I appreciate you and I love you.
Well said.
I love you too.
All right,
hugs and kisses.
All right, bye.
Bye.
There it is. Good stuff. Good times. Yeah, and if we have any more, just let me know. We can put other people on the line.
You bet.
They want to call in 720-669-6017 is the number on the show. Get a little bit of all right, there we go. John King, he says he's super official in the chat because he got the Aunt Berta shout out. nobody else did. Funny as hell. Philly, I just gave out the number. Aunt Berta, subscribe to the Sports Plus Life podcast. I'll entertain you. Ed, love it. TTF can't end the cast now. Can't make Aunt Berta cry. Brian Jackson. TTF, it's okay to shed a tear, bro. All love here. It's funny, my aunt called me the other morning and asked that too. She's like, hey, were you getting sad on the show? Were you about to cry? I was like, nah. Not about to cry. Because there's a lot of, you know, there's a lot of good. I mean, it's good and bad, man. For me, regardless of how it looks to other people, I feel really good going into 2021. I feel like it's just everything we needed. Everything we needed to do to move into the new year in a right way. We couldn't keep dragging this show halfway into the new year and then halfway trying to like find another job. Like it's got to be all or nothing. We knew it had to be all or nothing. And we knew we've put our all into making the content and the show and the entertainment value of the show great. We just didn't do as great in the other areas maybe. So yeah, spin. It's good, man. I feel really good. I feel really good. How do you feel moving into 2021? Do you feel good, like, as far as job opportunities, as far as the future, as far as the year, as far as your relationship, like, moving into the new, is it, you know?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, for me, I do feel good. I feel like opportunities are right around the corner for us. I'm trying to keep you out of the corporate world just because your creativity and what you bring with your arts and all this shit, man. I'm just trying to keep you away from that as much as I can.
See that video, the 2Js?
I did. I thought it was great, dude. I thought you killed that.
Thanks, dude.
Yeah, man. I was really impressed with that.
Took some good time on that. If you guys missed it, check out my IGTV. I put together the Chris Roberts interview from the last show, and then Dirty Erm was there. They put a vlog up on 2J's Kicks YouTube channel, and so I just took the video of Chris shopping in store and stuff and put it all together in a dope IGTV post on Instagram, so you guys can check that out. That shit's doing well, man. It's over 2,000 views. I put up late last night, like 10 o'clock, 10:30 last night. Not really great timing, but just right. Is what it is. But yeah, man, I would like to stay out of the, I'm with you. I mean, yeah, we've talked about some different things, working for different people, different partnerships, different stuff that's going on. I would love that. I would love to be able to get on paper and, continue to do the creative shit.
Yeah.
You know? And there's opportunities to do that. We just got to see what makes the most sense right now as far as my goals, leveling up, getting a crib.
Yeah.
So we got to see whatever makes sense as far as work and all that stuff. I saw Na Long asked a while ago, would I still be interested in getting back in telecom? He said his company's hiring. It really depends on what level we're at, what's going on. Mm-hmm. Nah. So yeah, hit me up on Twitter or whatever. Just DM me and we can chop it up and see. He said that they could use a guy like me. I don't know what position or what realm he's talking, but like I said, I'm down to hear from everybody.
Right.
I'm going to explore all the options going into January. That's what I'm excited about. I'm going to explore all these options, figure out what makes the most sense for me and my goals, what I'm trying to do. And if I can land the ultimate, get on paper, you know, good salary and continue to do what I do, it's all good. But if not, you know, we got to do whatever we got to do at the moment to make the other goals come, you know, come to fruition.
Yeah.
Got to take action, as they say.
Yeah, no doubt, man. I'm looking at, I'm looking at maybe getting a new house with Robin in the next year or two. Possibly, you know, we'll sell hers. I sold mine. I've got some equity that I'm just kind of sitting on. Looking at some investments, you know, where can I invest some of this money to make money for me, right? You know, so I don't have to be making all the money. You know, let your money work for you. That's kind of where my head's at. I'm excited, man. I don't think 2021 is going to start off with a banger and like us going to forget about 2020 and all the bullshit that's come with it. It's going to be a slow play, but I think just not having the show and have to concentrate 1,000% on the content and getting better and all this shit, we're just able to kind of see maybe these other opportunities that come, mm-hmm. you know, or maybe talk to people about other opportunities. And I think that's what I'm excited for us, and I'm excited also for you. I've got a couple jobs, may have another job lined up, who knows, but... Man, I just don't think we're going to be able to beat the opportunities that that may come our way this next year. Excited.
Oh yeah, it's going to be great. Dude, people are shooting over people are shooting over PayPal's. Misha just shot over $50.
Uh-oh.
For the PayPal.
Nice.
Justin McGuire sent over $20. Wishing you little token of my appreciation, wishing you guys the best in your future endeavors. Thanks, yeah. Justin.
Appreciate that shit.
Mish, appreciate you, dog. As always, man, the love is awesome. Thank you, guys, man. I appreciate it.
Unbelievable. Yeah.
Red Bird, good luck to you, boys. Thanks, bro. Dirty DJ, Dow, you could have killed it in Bitcoin. Woo, you guys seen that?
I know. Jeez.
I'm in there, but not like I should be.
That Bitcoin is off the chain right now.
I just pulled out like 60 G's out of the stock market and threw it in Bitcoin. Man.
You could have been Jeff Bezos.
Man.
Man.
Oh, Dirty DJ's McGuire. He's Jeff McGuire.
Oh,
my bad,
nice.
DJ, giving out your... My bad. Giving out your government issue. My fault. Oh, man. Choner says he's got the GoFundMe going. Over on Twitter as well. Yeah, Bitcoin's the place to be, man. The market's stupid right now. What did the market do today? Probably not good. Yeah. All just terrible. going into the holiday.
Just a bunch of uncertainty, huh?
Yeah. Going into the holiday, going into the new year. Just a bunch of poop. No big deal.
Bunch of poop. All right. I got a call from 267. Let's see what we got here.
All right. Oh, it's my fault. I had
it
down.
Oh, got it. Yo. Yo, what's up?
Yo, what up, fools?
What up, bro?
Philly Mayor.
Oh, oh Philly, Philly Mayor. Mayor. What's good, dude? How you doing, man?
Just chilling, man. About to actually get on the road here on 95, so can't talk too long. But just wanted to wish you guys great success in your future endeavors and stuff. Love the show while it lasted. And just wanted to give a call in because it's been a hell of a ride.
It has, Philly, dude. Everything you've done for the show, just trying to give us content, trying to like reach out and be like, yo, you guys talking about this today? You guys doing this today? Hey, you want to see these? Hey, can I send you these? Open me, you know, certain pairs of shoes. Obviously, you're paying resale, so I'm paying resale, but you're giving me deals on that shit. I mean, just always looking out, bro. Always looking out. Even back from like the sneaker review days, all that shit, dude. I really appreciate you, man. From the boost days to now.
Hey, man, that's what it's about. I was actually just thinking about the other day. I was looking at the L.A. to Chicago. So I was like, damn, I can't believe I got rid of those.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's funny. I was looking at those this morning, and I was thinking about wearing those to the show because I've never worn them on here. And I decided to go some different direction, but yeah, LA to Chicago's, it's so funny.
That's interesting. Not to be on your guys' wave, I was just thinking about those bitches last night and thinking about giving those up to Chris Roberts and making a sick trade deal because I don't want them anymore.
Oh.
I don't want them anymore. I don't want to distress them. I love that clean look, and for me to have to spend time and distress them and all that, it's almost like life. I used to be a big-time cardio installer. You know what I mean? I used to love customizing shit, like building shit, building boxes, the biggest stereos. And now, dude, I want shit factory clean. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And for me to, like, use alcohol and rub these bitches out and distress them, it's not for me. You know what? I'm just going to give those to Chris, and Chris can give me his Chicago Dunk Lows. I think that's a great trade. The money aligns. He wants those. I want those. That's what we're talking about. I might get rid of those.
Well, that's why I figured I'd give Thomas the LA to Chicago's, because I figured he'd be better at rubbing it out than me.
No, yeah, good one. Out. Wow, look at this guy.
Give them joints the old rub and tug. Hey, Philly, how do you like those? How do you like those NASA 4Ds? Are you pumped on those?
I actually sent them back.
Did you?
Even though I got a 12.5, like they fit long-wise, but they were still too narrow. Yeah. It's almost like the new Ultra Boost, like the Solars, where everything's super tight in the collar.
Yep.
And the 4D felt better. It just, I couldn't be comfortable wearing that. And I'm not going to sit there and stretch stuff out
right
with like a jar or anything like that. If it don't fit right, I'm not wasting my time on it.
Hey, a rumor is the Jameson bottles fit perfectly in there, and they'll stretch it out real nice. But yeah, if you don't want to go through that, I don't blame you. But dude, the new Prime Knit uppers on all the Ultra Boost, whether it's 4Ds or just regular Ultra Boost, they're awful. They're just awful. And you wonder why they're in outlets. You know what I mean? It's kind of a no-brainer for me. I'm disappointed. It's sad to see, but man, shit, a lot of those aren't working for us anymore. You know,
yeah.
And I'm with you.
I'll tell you what, I seen a couple pictures of the 2021 Ultra Boost, and I'm kind of intrigued with that. I mean, it's a little bit bigger of a boost outsole, but I kind of like the upper on it. It's a little bit more like, I don't know, it's got like different materials on it, but I don't know. I'm kind of digging it. I want to try it out.
Yeah, dude, they look way better than the 2020s. Just the model itself, the new Ultra Boost looks better. The ass, the boost ass on those, kind of appealing, man. Look really nice. The upper looks nice. I like the cages because they didn't do those stupid cages like they did on some of the late Ultra Boost OG pairs and then some of the 2020 models. I'm looking forward to it, man. I think it's going to be a comfortable shoe, and it looks more lifestyle than like super techie like the 2020s were. So, yeah, I'm excited.
Yeah.
You can put those
on the
screen.
Yeah, I mean, the 2019 was horrible.
Oh, dude. Awful, right?
I still haven't even tried one of those new ones, bro. I have not owned or bought a new Ultra Boost at all. I know the homie Vitzer likes the newer style for as far as just support. They're more supportive if you're trying to wear Ultra Boost as a lifestyle shoe. An Ultra Boost 2019 or a 2020 is going to be a lot more supportive than the other one, rolling your ankles and shit.
Yeah, I tried one of the 2019s on when I was at Lapstone and Hammer, but it just felt like you're almost on like a platform. I don't know. I didn't like the feeling of it.
Hmm. And those are the new joints. We have them up on screen now.
Yeah,
really.
I've got the...
That's the 2021s. I haven't even seen those.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, the upper has a resemblance of the OG 1.0s. I like the cage. It doesn't look awfully weird. The torsion above the boost looks good. And it's still a thin shoe. Looks pretty tempting. I'm not a big triple white guy, so I might stay away from that one. But I'm excited to see the colorways that they do. I like that
model. I saw on IG they had a picture of a white one, and then they had a picture of a red one that came out too.
Hmm. I'll have to check that out, see if I can find that.
Yeah,
I haven't seen that one. Only seen.
Well, I got to get going here, guys, because I'm about to get on the highway. But we'll keep in touch, and good luck with everything, guys. I know you guys will do something great in the future, but we'll keep in touch, and I'll talk to you guys later.
Appreciate you, man. Thanks for calling in.
Thanks, Philly. Good to talk to you, bro.
All right, guys. I'll see you.
Thanks later, man. Philly Mayor.
He didn't have the Philly accent.
What? Yeah. Oh, yeah, he does.
Does he?
Oh, yeah.
Man, he sounds like he's from the country to me.
No, I think he has. He's got that.
I wonder if he's moving to the country, going to eat a lot of peaches.
He's got that Pennsylvania.
Does he?
Yeah.
Maybe I haven't spent enough time in Pennsylvania.
Pennsylvania. Anna Choff, $20 in the Super Chat. Thanks for the great time, guys. Happy New Year, everyone. Happy New Year to you, too, bro.
Nice.
My aunt said, check your Venmo. She sent over $50 in the Super Chat.
We're rich.
Yeah, it's crazy.
I should have brought a whole drum set in here for one of the casts instead of just the cymbal.
Yeah.
I should have brought the whole damn drum set for all these Venmos and stuff that we're getting today. Dude, do some sick ass rolls on a big ass drum set.
Oh, dude. Yeah.
I mean,
nuts.
Shit, if people are paying, nuts. let us entertain.
Right.
That's what we're here for.
Right.
But I didn't. So. Instead, yep. I brought Wolf Grays. Jordan 5 golf shoes.
Right.
Instead. We got one more call. Let's get this out of the way here. 817, coming your way. Yo, you're on.
Hey, guys. It's Connor Terry.
What up, bro? Connor.
Can you hear us?
Oh, fuck.
Yeah, it looks like he dropped.
Did he?
Damn.
He's driving, I think.
Yeah, give us a call back, Connor, as soon as you can. We'll get you back on.
Yeah, I think he's driving.
Bummer.
It's crazy. Yeah, crazy stuff.
Yeah, no doubt, man.
Let me see. All right, we'll get him back on in a second, hopefully. So I was looking through the stuff here. All right, my music isn't even working now. Is it on our end? What's going on here? Oh, there we go.
There it is. Nice. All right, I think we're back. Let's see if we can get him here. Yo, you're back.
Hey, guys. Connor, how's it going?
Good, man. Good to hear from you.
Yeah, good to talk to you guys. I just wanted to address each you guys individually. I think y'all both bring two very different things to the podcast. So starting off with TTF, been watching the channel for a long time, got into it because of the shoes, and then whenever I heard that you were starting the podcast, I was super excited. Been watching since episode one, so I appreciate you putting in all the time and effort for the research and all that type of stuff. And then, you know, I really started my channel originally. I used to have a shoe YouTube channel. I started it because of you. I don't know. I was kind of inspired by your old channel and your old style. So I really appreciate everything that you put into it because I know hours upon hours. And then to Dal, obviously your background isn't necessarily as podcast formatted. As TTFs, but you definitely put in a lot of the personal stuff, like everyone has been saying, and I really appreciated that. It helped me get to know you guys better for sure, and I think you kind of balanced each other out and brought a perfect balance together. So really appreciate you guys putting in all this time and effort. And yeah, so that's pretty much it.
Man. Connor, that means the world, man. It really does. You know, like I said, I dealt with a lot of identities, you know, here and trying to figure out kind of my role. But yeah, like I said, being transparent, just being myself and being honest to a fault with the relationship, like I've said in the past, you know, I had to pay dearly for that in a lot of aspects. But, you know, I'm here for you guys. And if I had faults and I had tribulations and I had trouble within my relationship, within my work experience, I wanted you fools to know what I was dealing with. And that was important to me. And if you guys could not deal with the same shit that I had to, if I could teach you how to not, or don't do this, or don't say this. I remember John King giving me trouble all the time. Like, Dad, why the fuck did you just say that? It's just what I do. You know what I mean? And the Taoisms that come with that.
Yeah.
You know, you just got to be you. And I think as we look at YouTube, YouTubers and people on YouTube, we just don't know who they are. We think that we know who they are. And we think that they're a certain person. And then when you go to meet them, it's completely different. And Franchise and I just had the goal to be like, dude, let's just always be the way that we're going to be. There's just, with people like he and I, there's just no way that we could be other people.
Yeah.
There's no way that we could have alter egos. Now, can we turn up? Can we turn the notch up a little bit? Can we turn the dial up a little bit? Fuck yeah, we can. But, you know, man, that was important to us. And, dude, those words mean the most.
Yeah.
And the thing before Franchise kind of addresses you, dude, where'd you go skiing on your vacation?
I was skiing near the Vail area.
Okay, dope, man. Dope. How'd you like it?
It was a super fun week.
Fuck, we dropped him again.
Oh, did he?
Yeah, we dropped him again. Damn.
Ah, oh, damn it.
Sucks when you're driving, dude.
Number is 720-669-6017.
Yeah.
720-669-6017. Let's type it out in here again.
When should we get into our top five?
Shit, we can jump right into that right now.
Should we give the people what they want?
I don't know if that's what they want, but.
As you see on Twitter, everybody's giving their top five.
Right.
Should we? Do they care?
Yeah, I don't know. I don't know if they do or not.
I don't know. I think it might be interesting for them. Maybe your top five is a little interesting. So, again, I think your top five is going to maybe put some fools
on. It's not anything crazy. We can kind of blow through.
Yeah.
I mean, for mine. These are just shoes that these aren't all shoes that came out this year, but these are just shoes that I picked up, and maybe some of them, it wasn't intentional. Like I got the shoe and I just loved it way more than I thought I would. Some of them, they were intentional. So let's just start out with number five. And, it is the Jordan 1 Mocha. This is a shoe I was looking forward to since I saw the leaks, since I saw the leaked photos, since I saw that they, you know, initially some of them came out and they didn't have the black toe color blocking. They were all swell, all brown suede.
I remember that.
I just wanted them from the jump. I knew this was a pair that I was going to want to get in hand. I thought a lot of people would want them. And now we saw, I just tweeted out that resale the other day. It's up to $450 now.
Incredible, right?
Do you buy, like, if you wanted to resell the shoe, do you think these will hit eight by summer? I mean, that's the pace they're on here.
I know.
The pacing is crazy. When do these slow down here?
I think by summer they're hitting $650. I don't know if they're going to hit as much as eight.
Okay.
But I think by summertime you could see this $650, easy. So if you are trying to buy this, even if it's another pair or two, you don't have to invest all your money in this. Because this does make a part of my top five as well, which we'll get into. I think this is a great shoe to buy right now, even at $450, to make an extra $100-$150 here by summer. I do. If you can financially make sense of that, this shoe's only going to go up. There's no doubt about it. The ties to Travis Scott, the colorway, very neutral. You look at a year from now, I do see that somewhere around the eight. I do.
Yeah.
I do.
Next up, number four for me. This is a pair that I didn't think, I didn't know. I hit these on Sneakers app. I had no idea. The quality in hand, putting them on, I laced them up, put them on feet. I haven't worn them yet, but I just laced them up and put them on around in my loft upstairs on the carpet and worn them around. Dog, they look super dope. Like, it just looks like a chill pair of shoes that it will turn heads, and their quality is just ill on them. Like,
very nice.
It's just a very chill, like a subtle, dope shoe. Mm-hmm. And for $100 retail.
Right.
And to hit them at retail, I had to put this in the top five.
I'm impressed.
I really enjoy these.
I didn't think you were going to keep this. I mean, initially when you brought it in here, when we looked at it, the quality, that type of stuff, you appreciated it.
Yeah.
You saw good in it. But I didn't see this being a shoe for you. You're not a dunk low guy. You're not a low shoe guy. But this is one you're going to keep.
Yeah, it grew on me.
That's tight.
Grew on me quite a bit.
I'm glad to hear it.
Veneers.
Oh, I love these, dude. I love my pair. I've worn it twice. The quality, these and the plums, stupid good.
Yeah.
Stupid good. Yeah,
for sure. Next up, I think I copped these in April, and this was before they announced the release. I went back and got a pair of these. I saw the pair on GOAT, and I saw the leather quality, and it is the Michigan Dunks. So mine are from the 2016 release, which the leather quality is super sick on my pair. The 2020 release, if it's anything like the Iowas, it's just kind of whatever. Mm-hmm. Just really, you know, not just basic. That wasn't terrible, but it wasn't wasn't great. Not anything close to the 2016 pair. But this is a pair that I wanted in my collection for a while. They had an all suede pair that was really, really old that came out. Then they had the 2016 pair that came out. I contemplated quite a few times. I'm going back and grabbing those. Glad I finally did. I hate that they retroed them, and I hate that they came out with the new pair that's shittier quality.
That's not good.
But it's not like I was going to sell my old pair anyway. Right. So it's not like it really brought my value down or anything. It's just kind of whatever. But yeah, the Michigan Dunks, the 2016 pair. I'm happy to have those in the collection.
Those are sweet.
Next up, the we saw these on the show the other day, and I'm not making these number one only because I can't wear them. I have a size 9.5, or no, I have a size 9, excuse me, and it is the Black Fives Harlem Wrens Dunks. Love this pair. I have a dead stock pair, got the extra laces attached, the old school box with the certificate on the inside that tells you all about the Black Fives League and everything about that from the early 1900s. This is a pair that I'm so pumped to have. Love them.
The education background on this, the collector aspect, the color the color blocking is awesome, which we saw in the cast. The leather, like I said, is a little stiff, but I think this is a shoe that'll hold up, and it has really good meaning. This is a very, very well-done shoe. I'm happy to have seen it on the cast, man. Super cool shoe.
Yep, loved it. And then number one, another shoe that came out a while back, 2013, I believe, and I went back and grabbed them, and it's the Born in the USA Dunks. I just think these are super, super sick. They look great on feet. The detailing is all sick. Mm-hmm. Everything about them is dope to me. The jean kind of material that's distressed or whatever, they're not going to look bad as they get older. The red laces in them, super dope. Like, they just look ill.
Yeah.
So Born in the USA Dunks, my number one pickup.
What are those going for now? Have they skyrocketed?
Jeez, I haven't even looked.
Sixes, sevens?
Couldn't tell you. I can look, but
interesting.
Yeah, that's me, man. That's what I'm looking at.
It's a dope collection, man.
Connor said sorry. Yeah, he was having some terrible service issues. Glad I got to call in, say what I need to say. Thanks again, guys. Absolutely, Connor. Connor's been a young kid that was following the show when he was at school, in high school, and then he ended up getting a scholarship, I think, to Florida, went to Florida. Now he's a Gator. Sorry about your L last night. That sucks.
Right.
You're going to have plenty of success. Trask is pretty legit, it looks like, over there. But, yeah, man, shout out to Connor. It's cool to see a younger kid kind of grow with the channel. And now he's going into it's like where he becomes a man, you know, from high school into college. And then he probably picked up a lot of game, listened to a lot of our show, got a lot of laughs, got entertainment, maybe got some advice. And it's really cool. Really cool. So shout out to Connor, man, for being a longtime listener.
Talk about a leveling up story. Good for him.
Yeah, no shit.
Leveling up, you know what I mean?
Yeah, yeah.
All right, so I'll go with mine real quick. You know, I've got one shoe, actually, that is the same as you. That's about it. So we're quite different, which is nice. So for me, I'm a big tennis guy, always have been, and there's one guy that I followed immensely throughout my childhood and into, obviously, adolescence. Mr. Andre Agassi himself. So I had to go with the Air Tech Challenge 2s, man, the black lava colorway, as you see there on screen. I wore these the other day, and man, I was just reminded of how brilliant they are. They do not crease very bad. The leather on them is pretty good. They've got the Air Yeezy midsole, the infamous, you know, midsole that we've all grown to love because of the iconic grail. So it's got a lot of different elements to this. You know, the leather is good. The creasing is not bad. The midsole is notorious out there. And of course, my favorite tennis player of all time backed this shoe. So I just love this shoe, and it is pretty comfortable as well. So I just love the colorways. It goes with everything. That black, it just pops. You saw how much they pop in studio. I absolutely love this shoe. and was able to get this shoe at retail at the 130 via Misha. He sent me a link.
Love it.
When Kith restocked, and I was able to get it. So, again, it's people like you fools on the community, you know, that have helped us just as much as we've helped you. So let's go to number two. We won't spend much time on it. My number two is the Mochas, of course. I just think the quality on these are insane.
You started with number one?
Huh?
You didn't go five
down
to
one? No.
Five to four. Okay.
This is four. Sorry, my fault. So my number four, yes, is the Mochas, and I just think the quality on these is awesome. The similarities to, obviously, the Travis Scott, which, you know, none of us, at least that I know of in the community, really got, unless you paid resale. I just think they're super nice. They're super easy to wear. They're a great fall colorway. Jordan Brand killed it on this one. I don't know what else to say. We've already said it all. So great shoe, and this is only going to go up in value. So, again, something that you could even buy now and still make money on the future. This is a great Jordan 1 to sit on for a little bit. Number three for me. This one's interesting. This was one of the most hated shoes when the leaks first came out. I actually like the shoe. I like the concept of, or the story behind, supposedly, you know, I forget his name now, but obviously the owner of Union, how he used to fold his tongues over back when he was a young kid. I like that story. Now, what the validity is to that story, and if that's really true, or if it was just kind of a huge rumor that made it through the sneaker community, I don't know. But I think the concept is cool. The materials are astronomically great on this shoe. We brought it into the studio. And I think another reason why I absolutely love this shoe is, sure, it's hyped, but this is a shoe. This is a hyped shoe that I was able to get off of Union's website at retail. And the color of orange will be synonymous with me and sneaker culture forever, because that was obviously the tagline. That's what tried to fool the bots. Like, you had to answer the question, what color is an orange? And I'll just never forget about this and the experience of me being able to buy this as I'm assisting people in the golf shop at Murphy Creek, and then just hitting and getting that confirmation and going outside and just fucking acting crazy. And my boss is like, yo, what's he doing out there? And when I came back in, people were just like, yo, what happened? I'll just never forget that memory. It just was very, very synonymous with just being excited in 2020 when so much bullshit was happening, and it was this moment that I had where sneaker culture wasn't toxic, it wasn't shitty, and kind of came full circle and finally got a W. So happy to have it, man. So
love it.
Love that shoe. Number two. This was hard because I wanted this to be, this would have and could have and still can be sneaker of the year for me. I've loved this since they put this on the Air Max. I never was able to get that at retail, and never was able to pay as much as they were asking for that. But when the homie Chris Roberts comes through and says, yo, I got a deal for you, the Atmos Elephant Print Dunk SB. This shoe, the jade on that is beautiful. And I don't care what people say. A lot of people say the elephant print on this because of how black it was, and they messed it up from the previous generation, and that's why it's not a true Atmos and blah, blah, blah. The quality's good. You remember the toe box. That toe box was just a nice leather. The elephant print is synonymous. The jade pops. This is just one of the greatest.
I thought you were a little disappointed on the elephant print that day, though, I thought.
I was a little bit, just because it wasn't as true to form for OG. But you know what?
Now you're over it.
The more black it is, the more wearable it is. And I think it gives it a cool look. It's almost like, it reminds me of like gothic metal album covers, that black that's in the elephant print. Like, you see a lot of that dripping kind of weird look to it. So it kind of reminds me of some of the music that I grew up on as well. So I can always find the good in everything. Sure, I wish it could be more true to OG form. Sure, I wish it was an actual Atmos collab. But in this case, the color, the wearability, the symbolism of the jade and all this that they've done with previous OGs, I just absolutely love this shoe, and this is probably my second favorite or my favorite of the year. It's just a great shoe. Love that shoe. And to go with number one, this was kind of a story of the same thing, getting exclusive access. I've never had exclusive access before on Nike sneakers. And, you know, Soul Links, I think, tweeted out a link the night before, and they're like, yo, go ahead and check to see if you have access. And I was like, all right, good. Let's fucking try this stupid shit again. It makes you sign into sneakers. and I had the big black bold print that said exclusive access. So I was able to buy this the next morning. That is the Off-White Air Jordan 5 in the sale colorway. This shoe is absolutely beautiful, and the bulkiness of the fives that Franchise and I have talked about for so long that makes it so bulky and unwearable, Virgil fixed. He made everything about this shoe thin, which lightened the shoe. It also changed the padding. It also changed the way it fit you. So typically, you can't go true to size with the Off-White Jordan 5s. They run a little bit big because of all that padding that was removed from the shoe. So the way this fits, the lightweightness of it, removing the padding, removing a lot of the bulk, and this colorway is almost like an ugly duckling. They've made it vintage. And if any of you guys remember what I am, like, I'm really into vintage. You know, I love kind of the vintage stuff. I just was actually at a Goodwill. I hit a Goodwill up a couple days ago and went to the ARC finally. So trying to get back into that. Stay tuned to the Instagram because I might buy and sell some stuff just randomly. But the antique look that they did on the midsole, the extra yellowing, and obviously tinting this to make it look old when it is a brand new shoe, I absolutely love that, and it rings true for who I am. My mom, you know, we never shopped at malls when I was a kid. We always shopped at the Goodwills and the ARCs, and anything vintage and antique kind of takes me back to where I started, and this shoe does that for me as well. So, again, whether the shoe is the best out of any shoe that came out this year, the stories, the memories, and the why do you love shoes is why this one is the number one for me. So, yeah.
I love it.
There you go, man.
Good shit. Good explanations. Yeah, too. Good reasoning.
Yeah.
Really good stuff there. You were going to wear that five then?
Oh, fuck yeah.
Yeah.
It's right now, it's almost like a trophy, though. You know, like, right. You know, it's just so beautiful. It's better like this go get trophy.
Another pair.
I know, man. I mean, I might as well.
Where are those at right now?
640.
I was going to say.
My size.
Oh, okay. I was going to say five.
Not killer.
Yeah.
They might be cheaper in the bigger sizes, but yeah, in my size, about 640.
Yeah, it's not too bad. Yeah, man. Anything more? Any callers or anything?
One more call, looks like.
All right.
Let's get them on here. Yo, what's up?
Hey, how you guys doing? This is Nicholas.
Nicholas, what up?
What up?
What's good? How you doing? Sad to see the show disappear. I've been listening since the beginning when JJ was complaining about listening to the show five times, editing it, and I was like, I listened to it five times for fun. But you guys are always good. I bought a couple shoes for Dale's recommendation, those Nike Cruiser Ones.
Yeah.
Those are like the most comfortable shoes I've ever bought in my life.
Man, dude, that was funny about those.
Dog, Dale just wore those to the studio today. Because he didn't wear the rubber dunks because it's all snowy and shitty out here. Mm-hmm. So he brought the rubber dunks in studio and he wore those cruisers like he wears those as daily Duke beaters. Do you wear those to work too, Dale?
Yes.
Yeah, at work.
Absolutely.
And you love that? You said you love those, Nicholas?
Beaters.
Yeah. I bought them off of Nike after Dale bought them. And he said they were like the most comfortable shoes he ever wore. And I always wore Air Maxes. And after I bought those, they're my daily driver. Like I could work, you know, work for 8 hours and my feet won't be tired.
Yeah.
Hell yeah.
That's what's
and
up,
I never had Boost yet. I want to try them out since they got a lot cheaper since like the hype died down.
Oh yeah.
But I've always been a Nike head. So that's why I kind of stuck with the Cruiser Ones and I see Tinker made them. So, you know, you can't go wrong with anything Tinker made.
Right. Oh, dude, you got to try Boost, man, especially now. Like, I don't know if you tuned in last cast on Monday, but, dude, I got the Olive 1.0 Retros at the outlet, dog. So, like, you now can get really great shoes, dude. Even some of these retros that are coming out. I think they were $100, but I had a $10 coupon or something. So I got them for $90. Dog, you cannot beat that price for that type of comfort, man. So definitely check some outlets out if you got any Adidas by you.
Oh, yeah, I'll definitely check it out. I'll check out Adidas.com, too.
Yeah, man.
Because I've always been interested in Boost. It's just the fact that, you know, when the hype was so high on them, it was like, you know, sometimes, you know, you can't swing paying, you know, close to $400 on a pair of shoes that you're going to wear. So it's like,
right.
You know, you look for something more affordable.
Absolutely.
But, I'm definitely going to check the Boost out now that, like, you could find them a lot easier.
Yeah, man.
And, like, especially the 1.0s. It's like I never touched any of them, so I want to go for like one, two, and three. I know you guys don't like the 3.0s, but we'll see what's good.
Well, hey, a quick question for you. What size are you, Nick?
Yeah, 10 and a half sometimes.
Okay. Well, hey, do me a favor. DM me, man. DM me sometime today. I'm a 10, 10 and a half. I've got a bunch of boost, dude, in that size. Dude, I'll make you some sick deals, man.
Sick.
And dude, whatever you need, man. I'll send you some picks. I'll make you deals that you can't even get at the outlet, dog. Just let me know. I'd love to hook you up and get you boosted.
Oh, yeah, for sure. Yeah, I'll definitely DM you on Twitter or Instagram, because I know for some reason, my Twitter got suspended. I don't know exactly why. So I had to make like another burner account. So I'll probably just DM you on Instagram, because it'll probably be easier.
Nice. Hell yeah, man. Hell yeah. Well, hey, stop following those OnlyFans, man. Them shits will get you suspended, dog. I wouldn't know though.
Yeah, I think it was. I retweeted something Teddy posted. It was like one of his last average for oil.
Oh,
and
yeah.
I think they might have dinged because of that, but it was really weird because he was fine, but they got me. I don't know. And yeah. I'm trying to email Twitter, but they don't get back to you anymore.
Oh,
so
for sure.
The account might be dead.
Yeah.
But yeah, it was good talking to you guys. I mean, it was good listening to you guys every 2 days. I mean, I've always everybody else says, refreshing the YouTube, refreshing the Apple podcast, waiting for the thing to pop up. And even when it was back in the day when y'all were doing it recording and then JJ had to edit it, those days I had to wait an extra day or two, and it was worth the wait for sure.
Damn.
Crazy, dude.
That's awesome to hear, man. Appreciate that.
Rocking since the beginning, man. I appreciate you, Nicholas. Thank you, dude.
No doubt. Thank you.
Appreciate it, man.
Oh, yeah, for sure. Yeah, I mean, I appreciate you guys. I mean, it was definitely great listening to you, and I'm always – I'm definitely going to run the cast back for sure, because you're always going to be on YouTube. So, you'll be gone, but you'll never really be gone in everybody's heart.
Love hearing that, too.
It means the most.
So many classic moments, too, that we've all, forgot about.
Oh,
it's
yeah,
be
for
cool,
sure,
though.
Yeah. Yeah, and it was definitely nice, with all COVID, and then you guys still keeping the show going. So it was a nice, distraction from COVID. But yeah, I appreciate everything you guys done. And I mean, I hope it could go longer, but every good thing must come to an end. So it is what it is.
Yeah. Yeah. You'll see something from us in the future, I'm sure. I don't know what that'll be, but you'll find us in the future somehow, some way. Promise you that.
Oh, for sure. Yeah. I'm definitely excited for that. But yeah, I hope you guys the best, and I'll definitely keep in touch on social media with you guys. Okay. But I wish you guys the best, and have a great rest of your day.
Thank you so much, Nicholas, man. We really appreciate you, man. And don't forget to DM me, man. I'll get you hooked up.
Oh, for sure. Yeah, I appreciate you, man. I'll definitely DM. Thank you.
Sounds good,
bro.
I'll listen to the rest of the show.
Hell yeah,
thank
you,
buddy.
Bro.
Sounds good, man. Thank you.
All right. Good shit. I don't even remember that in neighborhood said could TTF do his old sign off. I don't even remember what that is.
is that the one? Remember you had me try to finish it a couple times.
No, it was way before that. Like
oh,
old like
it?
Vlog sign off.
Oh,
like,
shit, huh?
Like vlog. Like I know it was See You Fools Tomorrow, but I don't remember the rest before that. But that's funny in the chat.
Well, if I could remember it, I'll give you the stringer. Oh, shit. Is that pretty good?
Oh, that's right. love it. Everyone's getting their top fives in the chat. Love it.
Nice.
J-Dub killing kicks. What up, bro? How you doing? All right, man. I think you have anything more, Dow, before we get out of here?
Let's do one more call.
Okay.
One more call, and then we'll get the hell out of here. So 970, baby. Let's see who we got. Yo, what's up?
Hey, this is Donald Trump.
Hey. What up, Trump?
No, it's Chase, man.
What up, Chase?
Hey, what's up, guys? I wasn't gonna call in, but I couldn't turn down the opportunity. As you know, I have a face and a voice for emails, so I don't want to get on there. But
that's
good times. Thanks for calling in, bro.
Anyway, yeah, absolutely. And part of your segment is about shoes, and I don't know anything about that besides Kicks is cereal and. Part of person done. So
Such a Kansas boy, you know what I mean? Kicks? That's a serious, yeah, I'll tell you.
Exactly. Now, I just wanted to say, you know, during the work day, if I get time, listening to your segments of sports and life and even just being dumb assholes, you know, you guys really bring some entertainment to my life and I think a lot of other people's based on the calls. So just wanted to say, no matter what you decide to do, you guys got the drive and the, ingenuity to figure it out. And I'm not worried about you. I don't think anybody else is either. So.
Like I said on Twitter the other day, man, you've always supported everything I've done. You've been my homie. Shit, when I needed a place to move, you were like, yeah, move in here. I got a spare bedroom. Like, you've always had my back, dog, like, since we've known each other. I mean, since way back in the day when we were doing shit in high school and being idiots back then, man. So I just want to say thank you for still being here, man, still being one of my homies, bro. I appreciate it.
Yeah, for sure. Anyway, I don't want to take up the last part of your show, but take care, guys. Have a happy new year, and same to everybody else listening in. And we'll talk to you in 2021.
Hell yeah.
How about them Chiefs?
I know, right?
Yeah, I wasn't going to go there, but I'll take it. I'll take that all day.
Are you nervous? Are you nervous that they're looking a little light going into the playoffs, though?
What's that? I missed that.
Are you nervous? Do you feel like they look a little light going into the playoffs, or they're fine? They'll turn it on when they need to.
Yeah, man, they've been making me nervous the last 3 or 4 weeks, just playing down to their opponent, and mm-hmm. it's kind of worrying me. Plus, they're going to sit, you know, the big boys this week, and then they're off the second week. So, hopefully, they don't get too rusty just sitting around.
They're probably trolling us, dog. Like they're making us feel like we're gonna have issues. But dog, they're gonna run the table and just go back to back. So
I think so.
I mean, it's if you were to put a bet down on the Chiefs to win the Super Bowl, I'd say now is probably the best time, because now their stock is probably lower than at any time. The way they've been almost dropping games and playing down to competition, if you can get that line, I think the Chiefs repeat. That's mm-hmm. that's what I think still. I think they'll turn it on at the right time.
Well, Mahomes has been drinking too many of those silver bullets. He's not looked sharp the last couple weeks.
I know.
Better lay off the sauce.
He's Baker Mayfield style with all the ads and the commercials.
Yeah, no doubt.
He wishes he could grow a mustache like Baker Mayfield.
Oh, yeah. That fool's been wearing out his arm in the State Farm commercials, you know what I mean? Him and Aaron Rodgers, yeah.
Love it. Hey, thanks, Choner. Thanks for the Fantasy League again this year. Mm-hmm. I was telling Dow, this is the first time I've ever won high points and the championship, which is a very nice feat for me. So thank you for putting me in the league.
Let me know how you want it. Probably Venmo, right?
Yeah, Venmo's perfect. It's the best.
All right.
But thank you for that.
Well, thanks, guys.
All right, buddy.
Take care.
Thanks for calling in, Chiller. Right on, man.
Yep.
Good times.
Good guy.
Love that guy. Yeah, dude. Okay, Martin. Just wanted to say Happy New Year's, everyone. 2021 is a year to try and bounce back from this shitty-ass year. Down TTF, thank you for the podcast. Funny, chill dudes. Going to miss ya. Love. There you go. Oops. What happened?
It was me.
Oh.
I was just turning back the chat on because I had the phone on.
Oh, gotcha.
I still have the phone on, but I mean, I guess I could hang up. But I just wanted to see if there was anything in the chat that that I wasn't missing.
Yeah, I know. No, I was just trying to scroll that too.
Damn, we still have 44 people in there too, man. Damn, you fools are the best. Really appreciate you, man. Damn.
Anything more you want to say on the way out, Dal?
I've
covered.
Yeah, no, I think, stay locked to our socials, man, so we can still kind of hang out. I'll do a better job kind of posting my shoes and some updates now that that's all that we'll have. So keep it locked. I promise I'll make it worth your while. Maybe transition some of that into vintage, so any of you fools that are into vintage, keep an eye out for that as well. But I guess to end it on my side, just really appreciate all you guys and gals out there that follow. I appreciate your wives as well for dealing with us. And, you know, I can't imagine what listening to two idiots like us is like on a family vacation. You know, if you had us playing, you know, John King has us playing, and he said it many times, like, hey, my wife, she says no cussing, man, can't do it, you know. And for you fools to just be able to deal with us, but more importantly, your partners, for letting us in your homes. Man, I just can't thank you enough for the gifts, for helping us, you know, upgrade the studio for your for the Patreon that a lot of you guys have subscribed to and continue to, which we will be taking that down here eventually. It means the world, and the evolution. We were always trying to level up for you fools. Always had you guys in the back of our minds, or in the front of our minds, I should say. And man, thanks for staying locked. It meant the world. And thanks for promoting us on your socials, to your friends, to your families. It just means a lot. And yeah, thank you.
Well said. Like I said, man, you got the responses, man. I'm very appreciative. So, neighborhood, that's what it is, man. Yeah, just keep it locked to the socials. We'll keep you guys updated with everything, the future of life and everything that's going on. As we're on the job hunt and things there, may disconnect from socials for a little bit just to focus on everything that's going on, just to really hammer out a path to reach these goals over the next year or so. But as always, man, really appreciate you guys. Love you guys. Thanks again for tuning in for the last time. And in the meantime, in between time, you get yours.